Afternoon. Talladega is just a little over 2.5 miles in length. Its front stretch and back stretch are each 4,300 feet for the front stretch and 4,000 for the back stretch. And the banking is 33 degrees in the corners and 18 on the tri-oval straightaway. They'll go 188 laps, 500 miles. The field is separated by 4.5 miles an hour, and they'll need fuel somewhere between laps 52 and 58. Let's take a look at the starting lineup for today's race. The 15 Chevrolets, the 22 Fords, and the 6 Pontiacs that will make up the 43 cars, with Chevrolet leading the manufacturer's race. Bobby Labonte has his second straight restrictor plate pole, and Dale Earnhardt, a 7-time winner here at Talladega, on the front row. Row 2, Terry Labonte, who won last fall's race here, and Ken Schrader in his 400th career start. Morgan Shepherd has 13 top 10 finishes here, and Jeff Gordon, who was 5th last May. In the 4th row, it's Derek Cope, his second straight Talladega top 10 start, and Lake Speed, first top 10 start of 1998. Dale Jarrett will start 9th. He has 3 second place finishes here, and Randy LaJoy, who had a career best 5th place finish last week at Martinsville. Joe Nemechek, yesterday's winner in the Busch race, and Jerry Nadeau, the highest starter among the rookies. Starting 13th will be Ricky Rudd in his 43rd Talladega start, and Sterling Marlin, who has 5 restrictor plate race wins. As you take a look at the rest of the starting lineup, this indeed is a track of extremes. This is the track where the record for the most lead changes was established back in May of 1984, when 75 lead changes occurred. And the track that has the most different leaders, 26, that occurred in July of 1986.
See Darrell Walter, Kenny Irwin, the leading rookie contender, and Dennis Setzer driving for Bill Elliott this race. One race deal. David Green, Dave Marcus starting his 55th Talladega race. The winner last week, Bobby Hamilton, all the way back in row 15. Billy Standridge. And Billy Standridge, Jeff Bodine did not make the field today, so Standridge has the Phillips sponsorship on the 47 car today.
Dick Brooks won from the worst starting position back in 1973. He won from the 24 starting spot. The pole position really is not the best place to start historically. 11 winners have come from there. The second starting spot has produced the most winners, 16. Now we're back into the provisional starters, including Brett Bodine and Steve Grissom. And all alone back in row number 22, the 43rd starter is Robert Presley. A long list of drivers missed the field here this weekend, including Jeff Bodine, Hut Strickland, and Jeff Green, and Todd Bodine. So Brett Bodine, the only one of the 3 Bodine brothers who made the field. Here's Jerry Punch.
A problem for a couple of cars during last-minute inspection. Now, what NASCAR does is they put weights on the back of the cars to make sure the cars aren't too soft in the springs and don't dip down going through inspection. Rusty Wallace's Miller Lite Ford went through inspection, and when they put weights on the back of the car, they realized the rear sway bar was bound up with a chain. They brought the car back to the garage, put it up on jack stands, had to neutralize the car, which means take the front sway bar loose, the rear sway bar loose, reattach them, change the shocks, take it off the jack stands, and back through inspection. They just did get the car in line to roll off on the grid. Let's check in with Jack Arute.
Jerry, one car that didn't get in line in time was Kenny Schrader, starting his 400th career Winston Cup start. He actually took the command to start engines while he was still in inspection. Now, I checked with Andy Petrie. He said there was nothing wrong with the car. It's just that we got in line late. It took so much time to inspect all the cars that we ended up taking the command back in Gasoline Alley.
The cars have come off of quarter number 4 onto the tri-oval. They're looking for the green flag. Now, the start-finish line is located down by turn number 1. You can see the pace car making the hard left turn and going on to pit road as we are about to go green for the diehard 500 here at Talladega Super Speedway. 188 laps of racing around this 2.66 mile track. Bobby Labonte on the pole, outside of row number 1. Dale Earnhardt, who broke a long winless streak earlier this year at Daytona. The race is on.
believe it or not, it takes about 5 miles for these cars to get up to top speed. There we see the brothers with Bonte on the inside, Bobby and Terry trying to hook up, work toward the front. Meanwhile, the three abreast behind them.
And Schrader took a look up high, but he was blocked by Dale Earnhardt. Now the line forms two abreast as they go through the banking in turns three and four. First lap here. It's the 70th lap and third race that he has led in 1998.
Dale Jarrett hung right in the middle of the three abreast run. No one to work with. Meanwhile, Lake Speed, Mike Skinner trying to get by Jeff Gordon. They will sneak into line.
About seven or eight cars are running in single file formation. Then they're two by two and, in fact, three wide in some places as, again, they head for the 33 degrees of banking. There's Dale Jarrett in the middle between Sterling Marlin up high and Ricky Rudd on the inside. First lap, 162.7 miles an hour. This one will be faster because the engines are still getting up to full speed. Second lap, 190.533 for Bobby Labonte.
Sterling Marlin follows Joe Niemicek. This is the Coors Light onboard camera. I'm sorry, that's Jerry Nadeau that he's following. Niemicek, the car below, the 42 car.
They're still three wide now. John Andretti down to the inside in the 43 car. Elliott goes by Jarrett. Elliott in the 94 McDonald's-sponsored car. Right behind him is Ronnie Irvin.
And Jarrett just cannot find anyone to work with.
Back up on the right side, the high side of the racetrack. And look how low they are through the triangle, trioval, but you don't want to get those left side tires in that bottom lane because it's flat down there and can upset the car.
Exactly. You lose your wedge, it deals into the car, and the car can spin. Now Ricky Rudd is caught in the middle. Can he and Jarrett hook up? And Kyle Petty's also in the three abreast line.
We have seven cars that have broken away from the others, then three, and then this great group of cars. And again, they remain three wide. Ricky Rudd is the one in the middle. Riding along with the points leader going into this race, Rusty Wallace.
Ricky Rudd got caught in the middle. That allowed Dale Jarrett to get to the inside. And Rusty Wallace is down trying to get some help to work his way to the front.
And you can see that Bobby Labonte's last lap was 192.2, but he was not the fastest at the top five. Dale Jarrett lost 10 spots as he was caught there in the middle and couldn't find anybody to draft with him. Here's the front group of cars, Bobby Labonte, Terry Labonte, Dale Earnhardt, and Ken Schrader running in the top four. There are the top 10 as four of the 188 laps have been completed in the Die Hard 500. Back with more in just a moment.
What did that policeman want a while ago? Do you know?
Where? Huh?
Okay. number 8 about to be complete at Talladega Super Speedway. You're watching the action from high overhead Talladega Super Speedway, and the shots courtesy of the Pennzoil Copter Cam. 7 cars have broken away, and then we have a scramble for position behind that.
Yeah, the 7 cars are right now almost 2.5 seconds. Well, they are 2.5 seconds behind the leaders. There we see Bobby Labonte, the green car. That's the leader. Terry Labonte in second spot. Earnhardt is in third. Kenny Schrader is in fourth.
Morgan Shepherd behind him. Now we show you this second group of cars. John Andretti and Randy LaJoy have sort of broken away from those that continue to run side by side in the scramble for position. And now Wally Dallenbach in the green number 46 car heads for the bottom of the racetrack. Passes Derek Cope and may set up a 3-wide formation indeed.
Now Derek Cope, the 30 car, the black car is caught in the middle, no place to go, no one to draft with. Now they're 4 abreast.
Whoa! Sterling Marlin, the car on the bottom of the racetrack.
And Sterling has help. Dale Jarrett is trying to help him go forwards. He does. Ernie Irvin was the guy caught in the middle now. We're right along with Sterling Marlin as he follows the 30 car of Derek Cope.
And right behind him is Dale Jarrett, who again lost 10 positions in the opening couple of laps because he got caught in the middle. He's back to 20th position. This is from Michael Waltrip's onboard camera. He's moved up 8 spots since the drop of the green flag. That's Ward Burton ahead in the MBNA Pontiac.
Michael Waltrip is running 21st position as all the cars in that lead draft.
Riding along with the leader of the race, Bobby Labonte, leading only his 4th restrictor plate race of the 22 that he has competed in, but his 3rd straight. This is the Tabasco Hot Zone. We're checking out the telemetry, the RPMs on the top, and the miles per hour. Now there is a brake box, but I don't think you're going to see it very much, BP.
You certainly will not see it when we're riding along with the lead car. We might see it back in the pack. Some guys will not back off the accelerator, but they'll touch the brake with their left foot. And sometimes you can't back off the accelerator with the restrictor plate because the car just slows down. It's so difficult to build back up the speed. We see down the backstretch, 197 miles per hour. Last week at Martinsville, we saw over 9,000 RPMs. Here, only 6,800 RPMs because of the restrictor plate will not let the engine turn more than about 7,000 RPM.
But there isn't much variance from the slow speed to the top speed here, from about 192 to 197. That's the only difference there is from slowest to fastest around this racetrack.
The drivers, folks, never back off the throttle. Always on the floorboard. The only thing that slows the car down is when they drive down into the corner and hit those 33-degree banks. That will slow the car down about 3 miles.
There are 3 distinct packs now that have formed, and this is all because of drafting. Side by side, here's Cope on the top and Jarrett on the bottom.
I'd rather be in that first group. Looks a lot more sanitary to me than this group.
But so far, everybody has behaved very well. No close calls even so far in the first 12 laps of this race. We're on board with Ernie Irvin and the A1 Steak Sauce on board camera.
Listen to the engine and you never hear change sounds. Michael Waltrip trying to drive on the outside. There's that group of cars that are following. Caught in the middle of the 3-wide situation down in turn 1.
Jimmy Spencer on his right. Michael Waltrip is up ahead in the Citgo Ford. There they are, 3-wide, coming off the 33 degrees of banking and down the flat backstretch.
Darrell Waltrip trying to get in there, and he sneaks in front of Darrell Waltrip. That might have been a close call, Bob.
That was as close as we've seen, I believe. Rusty Wallace in this pack, running back in 27th position. Darrell Waltrip in the number 1 car, the yellow Pennzoil car that you see there, is substituting for Steve Hart, who was injured in Atlanta and is out in an indefinite period. Now the second pack has begun to catch the first pack, and all they have to do is stay in line the second pack, and they can catch up to that lead group. Jerry Punch.
Bob, cooperation is the key word at Talladega. There's been some discussions between Dale Earnhardt's car number 3 and Kenny Schrader's car number 33 between their crews about those two cars trying to pull out together to go by the brothers Labonte and possibly get 5 bonus points to lead a lap. But they thought more about it and said, hey, the 18 car is so strong and Terry is right with him. If we pull out in that second pack, will catch us and probably go by some of us because John Andretti is coming in a hurry in that 43 car.
He has caught now that lead group.
Ward Burton's leading the kind of like a third group, but I think he'll be able to run these cars down, and pretty soon Dale Jarrett will be on the tail end of the lead draft back in 20th spot. And all the next 20 cars are all in one big wad.
Nobody is trying anything fancy at the moment. Content to be just where they are to ride here for a few laps. Are about to be completed. Bobby Labonte from the pole position has led all the way so far. But now we have about a 20 car lead draft. There are the top 10 after 16 laps. We'll be back after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Matter, huh?
Sausage.
You shouldn't eat that stuff. Thank you. Welcome back to the Diehard 500 NASCAR Winston Cup race from Talladega Super Speedway. The story of the race until a couple of laps ago was patience as everybody was kind of following each other. But now we have our second leader of the afternoon, and this is how Bobby Labonte lost the lead.
Coming off turn two, that's Bobby Labonte in the green car. His brother Terry Labonte just moves out. Earnhardt goes with him. And around Terry Labonte goes. Earnhardt was not able to make that pass.
And now they have hung out Ken Schrader somewhat. Dale Earnhardt is running in second position.
And Wartburg, we saw him not too long ago leading a second pack. He's up challenging in the front pack now.
Again, they were patient and drafted up to this lead group of cars. They're three wide again here in the tri-oval. This time, Jeff Gordon is in the middle of Ward Burton on the bottom and John Andretti on top.
Wow. Earnhardt on the bottom with Kenny Schrader behind him. Bobby Labonte, we saw earlier about 195, 96 miles per hour. Now in the traffic, he slowed down, especially in traffic like this. It's three abreast.
Right now, a top speed of about 194 miles an hour. So when you're in traffic, Benny, do you think about lifting just a little bit in situations where the traffic is close?
No, you think about touching the brakes. That's all. Just to check the car, you touch the brakes as we see them three abreast behind us. Wally Dolan back to 46, the green car. Now they're just three abreast. I thought there was four. It's like Morgan Shepherd is caught in the middle. And Jeff Gordon, the 24 car, still in the middle. And Jerry Nadeau comes off the corner and squeezes right in.
Wow. That was close.
That was close.
Wally Dahlenbach always runs well at this track. He's in the 46 car and is up to sixth position. He started 21st. He's right ahead of Jeff Gordon.
And we saw Dale Jarrett lose those spots early when he got hung up. Well, he's back in his lead group.
Now Dale Earnhardt and Bobby Labonte are battling side by side for second. Here comes Wally Dahlenbach, and he's got Jeff Gordon to go with him. Meanwhile, Terry Labonte has opened up a bit of a lead, as much of a lead as we've seen. Sterling Marlin also moving up nicely.
Right now, Terry Labonte has a 1/3 of a second lead. Now, Schrader's the guy caught in the middle, and John Andretti. Schrader comes down, gets in that bottom groove, tries to follow Jeff Gordon. Jerry Nadeau also following.
Remember, Jerry Nadeau is a rookie, and again, they fan out about four wide, coming down the backstretch. Dale Jarrett trying to make up those lost positions. They are four wide and four.
And Michael Waltrip, another car that was running 21st just a moment ago. Was, I guess, there's 20 cars in this pack. More than 20 in that pack.
The Kodak car of Bobby Hamilton, last week's winner at Martinsville, is coming on. Jerry?
There had been a report, Bob, that something was leaking from the back of the four car, and we have talked to Robert Larkins and the crew who are huddling here in the pits. Apparently, there is an electric pump they're using for the first time on the rear-end cooler. Either that pump has quit working or is leaking. They have told Hamilton to shut the pump off, but you see the TV panel, they call it, the panel beneath the rear spoiler. It is turning dark on the car number four. Apparently, rear-end grease coming out the back of the car. You can see it from Martin's in car. Apparently Hamilton having a problem with the rear end. With that cooler cut off, it won't take long for it to get hot here at Talladega.
There we saw where I circled a moment ago. That's the oil that we were talking about, that Jerry Punch was talking about.
Well, Bobby Hamilton had moved up four positions to 26 from his starting spot, but now has lost a couple.
And Dahlenbach started back at 21st spot. Here he comes. He's battling for third spot. That's the first Union Chevrolet.
Jeff Gordon right behind him. And once again, we see Dale Jarrett trying to take a position away from Jeff Gordon. Let's go to Jackaroot.
That run by Wally Dallenbach has Kenny Schrader and his crew concerned. They don't like the fact that now things are stacked up. In fact, they warned Schrader about Dallenbach and the move to the inside and said, just take it easy right now.
Dallenbach started 21st, lost a position on lap one, but look at the progress that he's made since that time, all the way up to fourth position. And the last time he led a NASCAR Winston Cup race was in the fall event here last year. Ward Burton started 20th, and he's up to fifth. And Dale Jarrett is coming back to the front.
Battle with Burton for that fifth spot, and he has Kenny Schrader behind him. Sterling Vaughn watches this battle. He's right along with him. And we can see by this camera just how much the vibration of these cars, how much the car is shaking. And we can see the 22 car, just how rigid the back of that car seems.
To 22nd position on lap number five, and now currently is fifth, the highest position that he is occupied here on lap number 27. And once again, the first seven are single file through the tri-oval. Terry Labonte is at the front of the field, followed by Dale Earnhardt, Bobby Labonte, Wally Dallenbach, and Dale Jarrett, your top five. Bobby is way up high, isn't he?
He is. That's a sign of something ain't right, I think.
Now we're going to have a lead change. As you rejoin us here at Talladega, we have just had another lead change. It occurred over in turns 3 and 4 when Dale Earnhardt got some drafting help from Bobby Labonte. They both went around Terry, and now Dale Jarrett has also done so. So Terry Labonte drops from first to fourth, and we've still got him 3 wide back here, BP.
It's Ricky Rudd on the inside, the 10, Jerry Nadeau, Michael Waltrip in the middle, Blake Speed following Michael Waltrip.
Well, we've got horsepower from engines here this afternoon, but the Visa Triple Crown Challenge begins next Saturday with the 124th running of the Kentucky Derby. See how the country's top three-year-old stack up as they run for the roses at Churchill Downs Saturday at 4:30 Eastern, live on ABC Sports. Well, Jerry reported that there might be a problem with Bobby Hamilton's number four car, and indeed, he is on pit road. We saw some black stuff on the back of that car. Now Bobby finds his pit stall and the crew goes to work. Jerry is right there.
And the NASCAR officials are on their knees looking beneath the back of the car to see if something indeed is leaking from the rear end where they turned that cooler off for the rear end gear. They have changed right side tires, now left side tires. They fill it up full of gas. The car moves away as the leaders come by, and he will go a lap down. As Earnhardt comes by, he cannot get up to speed.
So Bobby Hamilton becomes the first to lose a lap here in this 188 lap race.
I think it's something other than the leak that caused Bobby Hamilton to come in the pits, because he's been running awfully high around the racetrack during the break. You and I commented just how high he was running. It's like he had a flat tire or the chassis was just way off. You might as well stop and check the tires and make a chassis adjustment.
Dale Earnhardt is the leader of the race. He has now led 36 of the 42 restrictor plate races that have been run. Those, of course, coming at Daytona and here at Talladega. Looked like that Bobby Labonte had some ideas of maybe going inside to see if he could get by, but it didn't work.
And John Andretti, the 43 car, dove to the inside, trying to take that fourth spot away from Terry Labonte. He's got help from Dahlenbach. Dahlenbach said, "I don't think I'll help. I think I'm just going to pass you."
And he does. Dahlenbach to the inside, passing John Andretti. And Wally Dahlenbach now is in fourth position. He brings Sterling Marlin with him. And look at their three wide again. That's Chad Little in the 97. Andretti in the 43 and Bobby Labonte in the 5.
And Chad Little started in 34th position.
Our field summary shows you the points as of now. Why is that important? Well, because every spot you move up or you lose definitely affects your standing in the point standings. Bobby Labonte has gone back to the lead, and look at this. Here comes Kenny Irwin, the rookie in 28.
He dives down to the inside. He's put him in about sixth spot. Well, we'll call that a tie for sixth anyway. Michael Waltrip trying to get on the inside of Michael, and it looks like he's as low as you can get.
And this is the time when you kind of hold your breath, because when they race this close at these speeds, something can and often does happen. They're still running in excess of 190 miles an hour at the front of the field.
And
four wide.
Yeah, four wide. We've been running about, I think we've completed 35 laps, so now the tires are getting warm. The chassis, if it's not perfect, it's starting to show up now. There's the lead, the left side of the screen. Bobby Labonte, Dale Jarrett, Dahlenbach is in third, Earnhardt, Sterling Marlin. And they're still hotly contesting that 12th spot.
Jerry Punch, what was the problem with Bobby Hamilton's car?
While NASCAR was checking for the rear end gear, the crew was changing tires. This is the right rear tire. Let me show you. I'm going to pour water and you're going to see a hole. See where the air is bubbling up from inside the tire? There was a cut in the right rear tire. Benny saw the car go high, said it's got to have a problem with the right rear. And Benny knew exactly what you were talking about.
Bobby now is running at the tail of the field a lap down. And look at Dale Jarrett.
Goes for the lead and takes it off turn four. Now, if he can lead down on the start-finish line, he will get those 5 bonus points for leading a lap. And Dahlenbach down to the inside. Can't make any progress.
Matter of fact, he's going to lose some spots because nobody is down there to draft along with him. Now, Dale Earnhardt goes to the inside of Bobby Labonte, and he gets some drafting help from Sterling Marlin, and so that inside line is going to leave Bobby just sitting there.
Jarrett in the first 37 laps has had a yo-yo of a race, hasn't he?
Boy, he sure has. All the way back to 22nd position in the opening laps, but now he has the lead. And they're still two abreast back of the first five. Now the inside line has again formed. Here comes John Andretti to make it three wide in the tri-oval as he goes inside of Dahlenbach.
He's got help from Kyle Petty. And both those cars just shoulder the line. Dahlenbach said, move over, buddy.
Dale Earnhardt now maybe getting the lead because he's got help from Sterling Marlin.
Jared, they passed Dale on the outside. He's trying to squeeze in. No, there's not room. And then, Bob, we see that 18 car goes up and runs in the back of Sterling Marlin. Trying to keep the 88 car from moving in that spot.
In the Tabasco hot zone once again, Bobby Labonte now at 189.
That's because he's got a car beside of him. See what happens when these cars get side by side, folks? How much they slow down? Perfect example.
And now he picks up speed again because he's got a car right in front of him in the form of Dale Jarrett.
But since he does have a car on the outside, I doubt we'll see that 193. Well, we see him 193. We probably will not go up to 195 like we did before. Getting a pretty good line. He's getting a good run as Sterling Marlin goes for the lead. And he takes Dale Jarrett with him, Labonte on the inside. Now Earnhardt's the guy in the middle.
Lead changes are only recorded at the start-finish line, but if Sterling Marlin can come around here and lead this lap, he will be the fifth leader of the race so far in the first 40 circuits. Derek Cope has a good run going up on the top of the racetrack. He's right behind Kenny Schrader in that green 33.
Derek Cope was another guy that's got a very good race car, had a good race car in Daytona. Today, they're getting shuffled to the back, and the good cars are working their way back to the front, just like Dale Jarrett, Derek Cope, Sterling Marlin.
Derek Cope sat out last weekend's race at Martinsville, recovering from some injuries, but he is pumped up for this race.
Where'd Bill Elliott come from? I didn't know he was in this mix, but there he is.
Well, he has come from 17th starting position, and yep, he's up there in the top 10. He's currently seventh.
Well, back in the 80s, Bill Elliott owned this racetrack.
More on Bill Elliott from Jackaroo.
Kenny, you want to know where Bill Elliott came from? Well, you better credit Jerry Nadeau, his teammate in the First Plus Financial car. When Elliott started to work his way and climb up the ladder, he teamed up with Nadeau. And I went over to Mike Beam and I said, are you two going to try and make a run to the front? Are you going to follow Jerry? He said, no, we're done with him. We're going without him now.
Oh, yes.
42 starts here at Talladega. Two victories for Bill Elliott. He's currently running in the ninth position. 41 laps have been completed. Live coverage of the Die Hard 500 here at Talladega on ABC Sports. Yeah, but he's right.
He's in the lead pack, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can he hold on, though? Oh, I love that. Okay. I love that shot, Mikey.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Working fine. Looks legit to me.
Got some. Thank you, Lynn.
Tell you what, that 43 car is pretty strong.
Yes, it is. Yep.
Man.
Wish you were out there, BP?
No. No. 39.
I should
cars.
Ask you that.
30. Hey, folks, you monitoring ESPN or ABC? Pretty good, huh? There you go. Not bad. Yeah, we got some folks listening to us, Mike. Yeah. Here comes Andretti. Oh, baby, baby, oh, baby.
And look at Kyle. Whoa.
Kyle, he watched that Busch race yesterday. He knows better. Somebody's on the apron. Who's that coming in the pits? Is that Presley again? Wow. Poor Dale. Okay.
As over 100,000 people look on, the Diehard 500 here at Talladega Super Speedway. 44 laps have been completed. We have been under green all time. And right now, up front, it's a battle between Sterling Marlin on the outside and John Andretti, who leads that inside line through the tri-oval at the line. Marlin, just by a fender, led that lap. This looks like the start of the race as they're two abreast, the whole field now running together. The 77 car, Robert Presley, lost a rear end gear. He's behind the wall. Everybody else is out there. Bobby Hamilton is the only other car not on the lead lap. And the 44 car of Kyle Petty has been impressive here in the early going.
He's right behind John Andretti. The 43 car is PE1, Petty Enterprises 1. That 44 car is Petty Enterprises 2, PE2.
From 32nd starting position to 4th at the end of 44 laps.
And Sterling moves over and helps that inside line. I don't know what that's all about, but he did anyway. And kind of left Earnhardt hung out on the outside.
I hear so many retired race drivers or those who didn't make the race say, boy, I wish I were out there. You wish you were out there, Benny?
No. I'm perfectly fine, Bob. Thank you very much, but I'm doing good.
Petty is trying. Look at that car dance around.
Look at that. I mean, that's what I'm talking about. And then inside that car, the vibration is incredible.
Kyle Petty trying to continue a streak here. He's been running at the finish of the last 12 straight races. His last DNF did not finish was in May of 1991. He was in the broadcast booth on ESPN yesterday during the Busch race, the ABC here, the Busch race. And I think he maybe learned some things during that race yesterday in terms of patience and experience.
Sure looks that way. It looks like he learned some things on setup, too, because this car is awfully fast.
Let's go down to Jackaroo.
You know, guys, we talk about all the time about how you need a dancing partner out on the racetrack at Talladega for the draft. Well, down here on pit road, you need a dancing partner as well. Andy Petrie went one pit over and talked to Jeff Gordon's crew chief, Ray Evernham. They have decided that they should pit together. But the problem is, Petrie had to find someone that was only going to take two tires because that's the battle plan right now. And Evernham said, Jeff Flake's only going with two. We'll come with you. Look for them shortly.
This is not a racetrack, Benny, that has excessive tire wear.
No, it didn't. The tires are not a problem at all. As a matter of fact, the tires might run for 500 miles, especially the left side. This is Bill Elliott's looking back at his right rear. And down the straightaway, you'd think that rear end would be hopping up and down a little bit. No, because those shocks are just have that rear end down on the ground. As it goes in the corner, you see how the spring compresses just a little bit, probably 3 or 4 inches. The fact that they're so weak is how they're compressing. There we hit a bump. This is a trailing arm. This long bar here is called a trailing arm. This actually comes on a Chevrolet pickup.
There's check the telemetry of the Tabasco hot zone on Bill Elliott. Oh, he hit the brake, Benny.
That's because he's following someone. He can't back out of the throttle, so to slow the car down, he's got to touch the brake.
Now picks up in the draft again. He's running in 11th position, Bill Elliott is. There he is. He has Randy LaJoy to the inside and Lake Speed right behind him. Bill Elliott with two wins here at Talladega. He won this spring race in 1985 and the second race in 1987. Bill Weber has a report from pit road.
Well, Kyle Petty may have learned something in the booth yesterday afternoon, but he learned a little more in happy hour. I talked to him this morning in the driver's meeting. He said he is as fast as the cars he's surrounded by. When he's with fast cars, his Pontiac is very quick. But in a slow pack, he can't seem to find the speed. He has found a fast partner in teammate John Andretti. Andretti was fast here yesterday morning, but when they put the race motor in and he went back out for happy hour, he was not as fast. Today, they went back to their qualifying motor. And now it's Andretti and Kyle Petty, both very fast on the racetrack. When Kyle comes in, two right side tires, fuel, and a drink of water.
I would guess that's what all the cars are going to do. And here's Jeff Gordon and Schrader coming down pit road.
They have to get their cars slowed down to 55 miles an hour.
I'm sorry, that's Ward Burton. I thought since Jack and Root came up with that. But Schrader did not come with Jeff Gordon. Gordon stopped. Jack.
And Benny, I can tell you why. Because Jeff Gordon will take four tires. Four tires, and that knocked him right out of the scenario. So what he's decided to do is pit with Randy LaJoy, his teammate, and Morgan Shepherd, and that's Dale Earnhardt's teammate. Those three cars are being worked on along with Ernie Irvin at this end of pit road. And away and it goes Jeff Gordon. And Randy LaJoy makes a track bar adjustment, but he's a little bit slower and has a problem refiring the car, but he's off and away.
This group off of pit road. Here comes Randy LaJoy, and here come the field at full speed. So these drivers are undoubtedly going to lose a lap here.
Yes, they'll never be able to get the car up to speed. And look at all these cars coming down pit road. Terry Labonte, Chad Little, Rusty Wallace, Rudd.
Down to Jack Arun again.
Once again, Terry Labonte's crew goes to work. The Kellogg's team taking a look at the outside tires. It'll be a four-tire stop for Terry Labonte. He knows what it takes to win here. And although maybe the tires could go long enough, they want to make sure. Let's go to Jeff Burton's pit stop and Dr. Jerry Punt.
The car was too tight. They're going to make an air pressure adjustment in the right front and right rear, and also they were going to change the track bar. Now they're working on trying to get the hood up in Jeff Burton's car. Apparently it is stalled on pit road. Frankie Stoddard and the crew working on the right side. They are talking to Burton on the radio as it was coming down pit road. It made a noise, and now they have raised the hood. This was not planned in the pit stop. As they are talking to Jeff Burton, and they are taking the window net down. Obviously not a good sign for the car number 99, the X-Side Ford. We'll double check with the crew and see exactly what may have happened coming down pit road and get back in just a moment.
Wow, a tough break for Jeff Burton, one of the Roush cars. You see other drivers making pit stops here. Brett Bodine is at the bottom of your screen. Meanwhile, it is Jimmy Spencer and Lake Speed who are exiting the pits, and here comes Kenny Wallace also. And again, here comes the lead pack.
The three car, Dale Earnhardt is the leader. We see Jeff Gordon right in front of Earnhardt. He would love to stay there just in case the caution flag would come out.
Bill Weber has the call of Kyle Petty's pit stop.
Well, Kyle Petty has slid through his pit stall. Now his team will have to push him back into the pits, and they'll have to make their two-tire change and put in the fuel. Kyle came zooming down pit road, went through his pit, could not apply the brakes. Now he's back in his stall, getting tires and fuel and a drink of water. Very disappointing. A great run going for Kyle Petty. Sterling Marlin has been in and out. Kyle's teammate John Andretti's also on pit road. Now Kyle takes off.
That was a tough break.
After gaining all those positions on the racetrack, he loses several in the pits. Here comes Dale Earnhardt, closely followed by Bobby Labonte, as other drivers now are making their first round of pit stops under green. Doc?
55 miles an hour down pit road. The key here is to get the car completely full of gas. Chevrolet for Earnhardt, Pontiac for Bobby Labonte as they begin to work on the right side of the Dale Earnhardt car. They are going to make an air pressure adjustment on the right side to tighten up the Goodman Chevrolet. They also were going to make a wedge adjustment in Bobby Labonte's Pontiac. He also was loose. Earnhardt is down the way. Towards Labonte. Here is Derek Cope. As Kenny Schrader comes out, they all head back to turn one at 55 miles an hour.
And you can drive faster on the highways here in Alabama than 55, but that's this pit road speed because NASCAR wants to make it as safe as possible for those crew members.
Yeah, you certainly don't have all the congestion on the highways you do have on pit road. The Jeff Gordon, that lead pack, Bill Elliott, that made the pit stop a few laps ago, looks like is going to catch that group of cars before they get up to full speed. I'm talking about Earnhardt, Bobby Labonte, Derek Cope, like Dale Jarrett also in that group.
So the field begins to sort itself out now after these first pit stops that had to be made under green. We've been green all the way here at the Diehard 500. We'll be back after this message and a word from our ABC stations. So who is leading this thing?
Earnhardt.
Earnhardt still is?
Boy, look at Dale Jarrett get that run off that second corner. Look at that.
Yeah.
Wow.
Mark Martin is a player all of a sudden here.
Where'd he come from? Two tires, I guess. Mark Martin's up there in the hunt. We need to find out if he changed two tires on his pit stop. I'm assuming he did.
Bobby Labonte just took the lead. The Diehard 500 is 59 laps old. We have had the first round of green flag pit stops, and now we find Bobby Labonte at the front of the field once again. We have two cars off the pace and off the track, as a matter of fact, Robert Presley and Jeff Burton. We saw him come in and push the car behind the wall. Jerry, let's talk with him.
climbed out of the X-side Ford. What happened?
It seems like something happened inside the engine. It almost acted like it scuffed a bearing or something. I'm not real sure what happened, but it's locked up pretty tight right now. They're going to look at it and see if there's any possible way they can get the X-side Ford back out. But it doesn't look very good. It's been a bad 3 weeks for us. We got a great race team. We just don't seem to be able to finish these races like we need to. We've blown a tire. I got us in a wreck last week, and now we've had an engine problem. And we got championship aspirations, and we got a team to win championships. We just don't right now. We can't finish races, and we're not championship caliber. We can't finish races.
Jeff Burton came into here 10th in the points. They probably will not get the car back out, but two of his teammates are making a move, Mark Martin and Chad Little.
Both running extremely well here at this point in the race. Chad Little is in fourth position, and Mark Martin is sixth. Bill Weber.
And Mark Martin has marched his way forward early, help from Rusty Wallace and Martin teammate Johnny Benson Jr. But now Martin on the move thanks to a two-tire stop and fuel in 12.06 seconds. Those teams have struggled on the track by themselves, but they are optimistic they can run well and maybe successfully defend today.
Well, the big story after qualifying was the relatively poor performance of the Roush cars, but they're racing okay, Benny.
Yes, they sure are. We've seen the 97 car, Chad Little, up there. As a matter of fact, he's currently running in fourth spot. And here we see Mark currently running in sixth spot. And also we see the speed, 195 miles per hour, as we go in the Tabasco hot zone.
He's got clean track ahead of him and a drafting partner in the form of Jeff Gordon. Jack has more on Jeff Gordon, the defending series Winston Cup champion.
And Bob, right now he feels like he's the odd man out. He's been back and forth on the radio with his crew chief Ray Evernham. He says every time we try to find a dance partner, they decide to leave us at the front door. They're not at all happy, and the one thing that Ray said on the radio was, Jeff, just remember who they are, because paybacks will come.
Right now he's running back in seventh position, just behind Mark Martin. Look at the gap between Mark Martin and Terry Labonte, who is in the fifth spot. But certainly an impressive run, Benny, for the 97 car of Chad Little, another one of those drivers that started way in the back of the field, 34th.
And Chad Little, another car that's owned by Jack Roush, or under his management, I'll put it that way. Following up on that great run he had in Texas just about 3 weeks ago.
His best finish here at Talladega came in the July race of 1992. He was fifth. Hasn't led a lap, but is at his highest position right now, fourth. And you see that he lost three positions from his starting position of 34th. Group of cars. There's the second group. We're waiting for the 44 car of Kyle Petty, who was up front until the pit stops. He overshot his pit. Things went very badly wrong during his pit stop, and he now finds himself back in 37th position, and probably worse than that, he's running by himself.
That's the worst part about this situation. He is running by himself, and these cars in front will probably be able to run 4 or 5 miles per hour faster than he can, the fact they're running nose to tail. Now, there's a couple of cars behind him that are hooked up. They might be able to catch him. If they do, then maybe they can run as fast as the leaders.
And there's only that much racetrack back to this lead group of cars.
As a matter of fact, Kyle Petty is 32 seconds behind Bobby Labonte. So you lose 5 seconds in the pits, but if you don't get hooked up with cars and get back on the racetrack, you lose a second or 2 seconds every lap that you run.
It's Bobby Labonte, Dale Earnhardt, Dale Jarrett, Chad Little, then the number 5 car of Terry Labonte, Mark Martin, and Jeff Gordon, your top 7. Completing the top 10, it's Derek Cope, Bill Elliott, and the 40 car of Sterling Marlin. Second in points going into this race, Jeremy Mayfield. Bill, is he having problems?
He had problems at the early portion of the race, Bob. Jeremy wasn't very good at practice. Obviously, he didn't qualify well, so they put in a new Larry Wallace motor today. In fact, at the beginning of the race, Jeremy was pretty darn good. Too good. He got too close to Bobby Hamilton. And when Hamilton started leaking oil, all that oil went all over Mayfield's windshield. He had to drop to the rear of the field because literally he could not see where he was going. He has a plastic sheet over that windshield, but because NASCAR has not allowed an extra man over the wall yet, the team did not have the manpower to pull that sheet off the windshield when Jeremy pitted. They cleaned it. It's better. But right now he's having trouble making up that track position he lost because basically had 190 miles an hour. He couldn't see where he was going.
Well, Jeremy's car owner is Michael Kratovas and Roger Penske. And Penske Racing got off to a great start. But in the last three races, neither Rusty Wallace nor Jeremy Mayfield has finished in the top five. Up front we go once again to see that Bobby Labonte continues to hang on to the lead. About a half a lap ahead of that group that we were just showing you.
Well, Jarrett sneaks out. Chad Little says, I'll go with you. He's going inside of Earnhardt.
Couple of Fords hooking up to pass by the Chevy of Dale Earnhardt and maybe the Pontiac of Bobby Labonte.
Chad moves up in front of Earnhardt. Kind of leaves Terry Labonte hung out on the inside. But here comes Jeff Gordon and Kenny Wallace.
Good run for Kenny Wallace, who also had a good pit stop to put him up here in the lead draft. Checking the speeds at the line. Look, Kenny was the fastest that lap.
That's because he was catching a draft down on the bottom of the racetrack. 196 mile per hour average.
Second was Ward Burton, and Derek Cope was third with that pass lap.
Now as we get caught up with the field and get to these other cars, they will slow down to the same speed the other cars are running.
Kenny working to the inside of Sterling Marlin, drafting on Jeff Gordon, who is drafting on Mark Martin, who was. Now Jeff gets hung out a bit.
Kenny got the chance to move out to the outside, and he dove it. Dennis Setzer, the dark car on the inside, our second-round fastest qualifier. Last down to our leader, Bobby Labonte.
This is the third car from the Bill Elliott stable. Besides Elliott, Elliott co-owns the 13 car driven by Jerry Nadeau with Dan Marino, and this third car was driven this weekend by Dennis Setzer. He has lost a lap, running back in 40th spot.
Battle for seventh spot between Sterling Marlin, Mark Martin. Derek Cope hung on the inside.
Field summary once again, showing you the points as of right now. Jeremy Mayfield, as you can see, has dropped to fifth in the point standings at the moment. Dale Jarrett has moved up to second.
Earnhardt, going by Chad Little. Terry Labonte is going by, and now Jeff Gordon's going to try to get by, and he will.
So they shuffle Chad Little now back.
Here comes Jarrett to the inside, trying to get by Labonte. Earnhardt's going to help him, and by he goes.
Terry Labonte has moved to third position as Bobby is left up on the top of the racetrack by himself. Jeff Gordon comes to fourth. Tight manufacturers points battle all year long so far in NASCAR Winston Cup competition. And there are the rookie points with Kenny Irwin with an 18-point advantage over Kevin LePage. And here's how they're running today. Irwin just one position ahead of Jerry Nadeau, and LePage back in 33rd spot. So now Dale Jarrett has moved his Ford to the front of the field, and Terry Labonte is back in second. And Dale Earnhardt third, followed by Jeff Gordon and Chad Little. We'll be back with more live coverage from Talladega after this.
Benny.
Yes. Okay.
Dahlenbeck just got a problem on the backstretch. Gone back coming to the pits.
What? Oh, I thought we were doing prime time. So coming up next. Oh, yeah? Okay. I'm going to tell you that we work with every year at the Brickyard 400. So Dahlin back, he says off the pace.
They've made it yet. Kevin and Charles, all
yep.
The guys rocking it.
Yep. No kidding. Wow. That'll give me something to do. You want me to mention that? Great. See you, bud. NASCAR Winston Cup Racing at Talladega coming up next. Toyota presents the AMA Supercross Motorcycle Championship. Catch the wild racing excitement as the hottest Supercross drivers tear up the track at Texas Stadium. It's next after the conclusion of the Die Hard 500 here on ABC Sports.
There's Randy LaJoy, clean racetrack in front of him. Unfortunately, the 25th place car, Ted Musgrave, a little distance in front of him.
Terry Labonte has the lead. Jeff Gordon now second, riding along with Bobby Labonte, who has led the most laps so far here this afternoon. He has been at the front of the field for 30 circuits. Terry's about to lead his 15th lap. Once again, we're beginning to see two distinct packs being formed here at the front of the field, as about seven cars have broken away from Mark Martin, Sterling Marlin, and others.
If those back cars will just get in line, I think they'll be able to run the leaders down. But if they persist on running side by side like that, then they're going to have a problem.
That's Chad Little up high.
And Earnhardt. All of a sudden, Earnhardt's out of that lead group back there. I wonder if he's got a problem.
Well, he certainly is falling back here. Lost several spots in the last couple of laps.
Back to 12th spot.
That's Morgan Shepherd in the 31 car that was driven earlier this year by Mike Skinner. He, too, on the mend from injuries. There is Rusty Wallace as he runs to the inside of John Andretti. They're running back in
16th, 17th.
Yep. Well, we hear there's no problem for Dale Earnhardt in terms of the car. Just got shuffled back.
Well, these two cars really need to get nose to tail, Rusty and John Andretti. And maybe they will now. Yeah, Rusty just moves up the racetrack and says, John, please follow me, will you?
They heard you. Dahlenbach has gone behind the wall. Remember, in the early going, he was right up there amongst them. Bill Weber, what's the problem?
Well, a lot going on back here in the garage. First of all, for Wally Dahlenbach, they believe it's a right rear shock that is broken. He's behind the wall. This car fell off the jack a moment ago, a frightening moment, but everybody was okay. They work underneath the car, working on the right rear shock and looking at the left rear shock. Dave Marquez is parked right next to him. He has complained about a possible shock problem. Right now, they believe it may be the rear end gear going bad. So the 46 of Dahlenbach, the 71 of Marquez behind the wall.
Does is keep that, this is Bill Elliott's car, and it keeps this thing from being too violent. I was watching Dahlenbach when he went in turn one a moment ago, and he just almost crashed, and I guess that's when the shock broke or whatever broke. They're assuming it's a shock.
Tabasco hot zone information for you, 196 miles an hour at just under 7,000 RPM. Elliott is running in sixth position. Dave Marquez is behind the wall. This was his 55th start here at Talladega, the most of any driver.
Well, Bill Elliott's running sixth spot, but the best thing about it, he can see the leader. He's only about six or seven car lengths in front of him is Kenny Wallace. He's running the seventh spot. Great run for Kenny. Look, 198 miles per hour. Going through the corner, only slowing down to 194, 93, 192. He slowed down 5 miles per hour. I saw Martin Marr's car a moment ago. He really didn't slow down. He stayed about the same speed. He wasn't as fast as Elliott on the straightaway, but he didn't slow down as much in the corner. Look at that spring compressed as he hits the bumps. They use springs that you normally would use at a... Actually, NASCAR mandates they have to use like a 350-pound spring, a spring that will take 350 pounds of pressure to compress it 1 inch.
Boy, Kenny Wallace has got a good run going here. He started back in 35th position. Right now, finds himself in seventh at the tail end of this lead draft. He began moving up and has moved up steadily to this position. His best finish here at Talladega came back in the July race of 1994 when he finished ninth. And there's Kyle Petty, Benny, being last.
Yeah, he had a great run going earlier on, but that bad pit stop. And as a matter of fact, he's got to keep up with this group of cars once they get by him. That's Billy Standridge, the 47 car that has been lapped along with Kyle.
Henry cars are up front, Jackaroo, Lamani, and Gordon.
And they are going to come right down into pit road together. I talked to Andy Graves and to Ray Evernham, crew chiefs for the leader and second place respectively. They say they're going to come in together. Might as well, they're teammates. But here's what's interesting, guys. They feel they can only go to about lap 104. Meanwhile, further down the road, Mike Beam and company have calculated that they can keep Bill Elliott and McDonald's Ford out until lap 112 to be safe, and as long as 116. So it could be interesting to see who pits and when.
Right now, the Henry cars are setting the pace. You saw Bobby Hamilton get lapped again. He's now two laps off the pace, back in 39th position. Seven cars running here in the lead draft.
And they're just 3/4 of a second between the first car, Terry Labonte, and back to Kenny Wallace. Now there comes the next group of cars, led by Mark Martin, Sterling Marlin, Ward Burton, Chad Little, and Dale Earnhardt. Now they're in line, and they should be able to at least maintain the distance between themselves and the front pack. We'll check it. Right now they're 2 3/4 seconds behind the last lap. We'll check it out.
Mark Martin, leading this second group, has won twice here at Talladega, this race in 95 and 97. Jerry, you're hearing of other teams are going to team up?
Bob, they're lined up by manufacturer. The top two are Chevrolet, the next two are Pontiac, and the next four are Ford. Now, we're being told the Pontiac's in the middle there. We're talking about the 18 car, Bobby Labonte, and the 30 of Derek Cope are thinking about teaming up together to try to go by the two Chevrolets, the 5 and the 24. But they're concerned, the three Fords right behind the 30 car, led by Dale Jarrett, Bill Elliott, etc. If they make the wrong move, they will get passed on the high side. So teamwork now by manufacturer, Chevrolet, Pontiac, and then Ford.
Well, those guys didn't stay in line, as you can see.
We've got some traffic to go through here in the form of Bobby Hamilton.
Now they are back on. Sterling Marlin tried to make a pass. He was running second in this group behind Mark Martin, is now at the very end of the, there he is at the very end. So he lost four spots. Got a little greedy there, Sterling.
This is under the 36 car now of Ernie Irvin.
This is the, you see the gear? This is the rear end cooler pump. That's a pulley that pulls, that turns.
Should that be moving now?
Oh, yeah, it is turning.
Is it?
It's just turning so fast that it does look like it's turning.
Okay.
Yeah. That pulls the fluid out of the rear gearing up into a small radiator. A fan blows air through it and cools that fluid in the rear gearing.
Is Ernie running behind Rusty Wallace and ahead of Lake Speed?
Currently running in the 17th spot.
Those guys have lined up to try to lessen the distance between themselves and the next group.
They're 15 seconds behind the leader.
Kenny Schrader earlier was running up in the top five, and now he is trying to draft with this group. He's back in 20th spot.
There we see Terry Labonte, the leader of the race. Jeff Gordon is in second. Bobby Labonte is third. Derek Cope. Now we see him go back to Mark Martin in this group. And we saw him trying to race him just a moment ago. They lost 3/4 of a second. Right now, they're 4.5 seconds behind. So they've lost 1.75 seconds since we started checking this just a moment ago.
Here is this group led by Rusty Wallace back in the 16th position. 86 laps completed out of 188 that make up the diehard 500 NASCAR Winston Cup race from Talladega Super Speedway in Alabama.
They said anything down there, Ned? They say anything much up there?
Ned, who let him in the booth?
Huh?
Just been here. But we can promote it as being on at 1 o'clock ESPN. You want me to mention it? You want me to mention it, Neil?
The 30 and the 81 got shuffled out of the draft.
Okay, this is it. Obviously, BP, this is the right rear shock off Wally's car. You push it down, it's supposed to rebound, but not that fast. The inside of the right rear shock went away, so they changed it and sent him back out.
Yeah.
Should recoil, rebound a lot slower than that.
Well, that's right. Should stay down and hold that back in there.
Right.
Yeah.
Yes. Ha, Now just four cars in the lead draft. Terry Labonte, Jeff Gordon, Bobby Labonte, and Dale Jarrett. Tonight on ABC, The Wonderful World of Disney gives you your first look inside Disney's newest world, Disney's Animal Kingdom, The First Adventure. Then at 8, 7 Central, Tom Hanks, Gary Sinise, Kathleen Quinlan, and Ed Harris star in the network's premiere of one of the best films that you will ever see, Ron Howard's Apollo 13, tonight on ABC.
Well, I don't agree with much you say, Bob, but I will agree with that.
It indeed is. Well, these cars are traveling like rocket ships around this racetrack, setting a pace in excess of 190 miles an hour, and 90 laps have been completed. One car that had problems was Wally Dallenbach. He's back on the track now. Bill, give us a synopsis of what happened.
Well, Bob, this is the right rear shock off the first Union Chevrolet. And Benny, I'm going to run out of hands here, so you talk while I demonstrate. This is obviously very hot. And the purpose of this shock is to hold the car down. But the inside of this shock has gone away. So when you compress it, it has a very rapid rebound. And that's obviously not what's supposed to happen.
Yeah, the rebound, that's compression. When he lets go, that's supposed to stay down there and hold the back of that car down. And you can see, folks, it's just not doing it. Good job, Bill.
And my mic wrecked.
That's okay, as long as you're all right. Well, there is Wally, who is back on the racetrack. However, he lost 13 laps during the shock change. We are at record pace. Remember a year ago, we ran without a caution, and the pace was 188.3 miles an hour, set by Mark Martin. Well, we're even above that today, as so far, again, no cautions. Let's hope it goes the rest of the way without.
Dick Kirk of the 90 car driving, diving down to the inside, trying to get by Jeremy Mayfield. Jerry Nadeau on the outside. They're three less, and it almost goes up. And once again, Jerry said, look, they're trying to do that to me.
Wow.
Those guys are running back in the 30th, 31st positions.
Back up front, meanwhile, it is Terry Labonte who continues to lead the way. Dale Jarrett running in fourth position, Jerry.
Bob, that's the good news. DJ running fourth in the lead draft. The bad news is he will not be there for very long. The problem they had on lap 54 when they changed two tires, they wanted DJ, Dale Jarrett, to stay and wait until he heard the word go before he left that road to get it full of fuel. He heard someone say no, and he left the car not full of fuel. He will pit in about three or four laps, which puts him about 12 to 14 laps shy of when the other leaders will pit.
And again, that can be devastating to you after you gain all those positions on the racetrack and then have to do that, especially if you come out without a drafting partner. Again, as a field summary, points as of now. Note again, Jeremy Mayfield was second going into this race, and right now his point position is fifth.
And he's only lost about 20 positions, so you can see just how much the other contenders have gained on the leader.
Terry Labonte continues to lead this race. He led 70 laps last October.
And for you folks that are Earnhardt Martin, fans, they have gained about 1 second on these four cars in the last 10 laps or so. There we see the 30 car, 81-90. They've lost that lead, and they've fallen back about a second and three quarters behind the leaders. And Earnhardt, Ward Burton, Mark Martin, Chad Little, Sterling Marlin, they're only about a second and a half behind these guys.
Here's an AutoZone on-track interval of Dale Jarrett in fourth and Derek Cope in fifth position. Derek has been able to close that gap by about 2/10 of a second, laps 89 through 93.
And look at Jarrett, 50.20101. How consistent, just 1/10 of a second separating those laps. And you see Derek Cope, the one lap that really hurt him was at 50.5. He had one good lap at 49.9.
Yep.
But that one bad lap, 50.5, when he had to back out the accelerator for some reason, someone got beside of him or whatever, and that just cost him.
Riding along with Bill Elliott, who's running in seventh spot. Up ahead is the sixth place car of Kenny Wallace. Rusty Wallace, the points leader going into this event, is maintaining his points lead, but he is in somewhat of a struggle here this afternoon, running back in 22nd position. There have been 41 restrictor plate races at both Daytona and here at Talladega. He's never won two top fives, 12 top tens, and 12 DNFs, but he has three straight top tens, so he is beginning to figure out Daytona and Talladega in terms of restrictor plate racing. Terry Labonte, his last NASCAR Winston Cup win here last August. This is his 578th straight NASCAR Winston Cup start. Dale Jarrett's crew is ready for his pit stop.
Terry Labonte has won the Gatorade Challenge. That's the leader halfway. Picks up about $10,000.
So already he has picked up 10 grand, and we're halfway through this race. Dale Jarrett looks like he's slowing down and coming in for that pit stop. Indeed, Jerry Punch, he's coming off the banking and headed toward you.
41-year-old Dale Jarrett brings the quality car forward down pit road all alone, and it's a lonely feeling. He did not get the car full of fuel when he left early on their first and only stop on lap 54. He comes in very deliberately. Remind him, 55 miles an hour. They will change all four tires. No chassis adjustment, no air pressure change, and no dance partner, no one to help him get back up there in the draft. Right side tires going on. One can of fuel in. Now they're watching. They will hold the car to make sure they get it completely full of fuel. It is full of fuel already. Left front tire on. Now tire is loose. Left rear tire finally going on. And he is moving down and away. Who can he hook up with to possibly draft back toward the front? Leadership pit in 10 or 12 laps.
And here comes the lead group of cars through the tri-oval.
Well, he will not be able to catch up with these cars. They go blowing by him. To go by because he's still not up to speed.
These restrictor plate motors just cannot get up to speed that quickly. So now five cars up in the lead draft. And a very lonely feeling for Dale Jarrett here at Talladega.
Yes, just to watch those cars drive away and be able to do nothing about it.
Terry Labonte continues to lead. He is the ninth different driver to be leading at the halfway point in NASCAR Winston Cup competition. We'll be back after these messages and a word from our ABC stations. Thank you very much.
just came out of the pits.
Mid-race recap until we have pit stops. Okay. Back at Talladega Super Speedway in Alabama, it's the Die Hard 500. The story of the race so far, Terry Labonte among others. He's at the front of the field right now. We have just seen some pit stops. Martin relinquished his ninth position to come in for a pit stop. Of course, Dale Jarrett did earlier. Ernie Irvin is in, and we'll see these five drivers at the front of the field in before too long. Jack Arouk, can you see Ernie Irvin's pit stop?
Absolutely, and right now it's a two-tire stop, but they had to take the longest period of time to make sure that the car was filled with fuel. That's when they say gas men just love that kind of pressure. And today, it's about to take place for not only your first place car, Terry Labonte, but his teammate, Jeff Gordon, because they will pit in just two laps.
As we see Ernie Irvin lead, that's going to be about perfect because that the leaders, there are five cars that are bunched together leading the race. Terry Labonte, Jeff Gordon, Bobby Labonte, Derek Cope, and Kenny Walsh are about to catch a group of slower cars, which could slow them down. Obviously, the best thing to do would be come pits. And here comes Terry Labonte. Here comes Jeff Gordon. All five cars going to pit together, trying to stay in that lead together, trying to stay in a group together so they can draft together. Jack Arouk.
Now, the key now is to maintain the speed limit. The way they do that is check the RPM in second gear. It should be 4,800 RPM. First man to hit the spots because he's closer is Gordon. But Labonte's crew goes to work. Now, Labonte's team will take on four tires. We'll wait to see. Yes, Gordon will as well. So this will be a nominal stop for both teams. No changes are anticipated, Jerry.
All right, four tire changes going on Bobby Labonte's Interstate Battery Pontiac. They're already on the left side. They just moved to the left side now of the Goodrich Chevrolet for new car. Bobby Labonte is down and away. Left front tire going on the three car. Left rear, they're getting completely full of fuel, clean the windshield, and he is away just behind the 30 car of Derek Cope. Let's go to Jack Arouk.
So Jerry, Ricky Rudd completes his term on pit road as Kenny Irwin comes in. Now, Kenny Irwin's crew and the Havily team, they're going to put two rounds of bite into the right side. They're also just taking right side tires, and he's off and away with a full tank of Union 76.
Uh-oh, we have a car slowing. It's like that the 47 car standard cut a tire.
Looks like he's made some contact with the wall. And there's a piece of debris on the racetrack. Oh, man, these guys that have not stopped could get a caution flag.
Very interesting situation. At the front of the field right now is Michael Waltrip in the Wood Brothers car. Now, if the caution does come out, how will this mean an advantage for these guys?
Well, there's going to be several cars that are lapped down. It goes back to about the 19th position. Ernie Irvin is still in the lead lap. And the leaders, the Labonte brothers and Jeff Gordon, they're still in the lead lap.
That's looks like a piece of rubber back there in the backstretch. It is not a piece of sharp debris. And so far, we have no caution as the green remains out. Standridge has made his way around to the pits here. That, however, may be a piece of metal.
Certainly looks like a piece of aluminum to me.
Yep. Well, Michael Waltrip now has the lead with Kenny Schrader running in second position. Jimmy Spencer is in third.
And Terry Labonte is still in third spot because most of the cars have made a pit stop. And Spencer trying to get a run on. That's not Spencer on the outside.
I believe it's John Andretti and Ernie Irvin as Michael Waltrip, Kenny Schrader, and Jimmy Spencer all decide that this is the time to come in. Jack Arouk.
Well, here's where things worked out very well, not only for Michael Waltrip, Kenny Schrader, and Jimmy Spencer. They have run the string out just a little bit further. We'll see if Schrader opts to stay with his two-tire strategy. Remember, they changed two tires the last time under green flag conditions. They've taken on the tank a few. They're going to go for four tires. Jerry.
And the Citgo Ford of Michael Waltrip on pit road. Remember the great run he had in Daytona when he finished second in the 125-mile qualifier. He will also take on four tires. Kenny Schrader is down, headed down pit road, back toward turn one. Michael Waltrip off the jack. He too puts it back in gear and drives away.
Jimmy Spencer won that race off of pit road. He came in. That's Michael Waltrip. The caution now is out. The caution waves. For the first time this afternoon, here at on the 109th lap, NASCAR flagman waves the caution.
And what NASCAR did, and here's the battle. These cars are trying to get a lap back. The 46 and 16 trying to beat the 5 car back. And look at all this group of cars in front of the leader as long as they get back to the line. And Mustrade does.
Not quite yet because they haven't reached the line, but it looks like yes, he will. And Wally Dallenbach got one of his laps back, but he's some 12 laps from the lead lap.
What NASCAR did, and really, truly, it was a wise thing to do. They waited until everyone had made their pit stop and then decided to throw the caution flag.
So nobody would have been given an advantage. It was a piece of debris on the backstretch, and this is Billy Standridge coming down the backstretch, and look, the tire disintegrates.
And we saw the piece of debris fly off the track. Now, not that before. The tire just comes apart and tears the fender almost off the car. And that sponsor on the hood of the car, once again, Jeff Bodine sponsor, Phillips, on Standridge's car today.
First time this afternoon, the pace is slowed here at Talladega as caution has come out. We'll take a break and be right back with more.
Here's a unique way NASCAR Winston Cup team.
Man, there's a bunch of cars about to go lap down, wasn't there?
At Talladega, where the caution waves over the speedway for the first time this afternoon, Terry Labonte is the leader of the race. Several cars just avoided going a lap down. We are now 29 cars in the lead lap. Let's take a look at the Bud race recap. Terry Labonte at the front of the field has led 49 laps of the 111 that we have completed so far. 12 lead changes, only one caution. We are currently in it, and the average speed at 182.5 miles an hour. Taking a look at the drivers who have picked up 5 bonus points for leading a lap, Labonte has led the most so far. Michael Waltrip gets credit for leading 3 laps, and those are the first laps that he has led in 1998. And only one car is on the out-of-race panel, that Jeff Burton, who is certainly taking a blow in the point standings because of that. Bill Weber.
Well, Bob, I want you to know there is some exciting and frantic action here along pit road. Under that caution period, 3 of the Roush cars came in. For Mark Martin, he'd gotten right side tires on his first 2 stops. That time, he topped off with fuel, got 2 lefts. Benson was in. He'd gotten 2 lefts on the previous stop. He got 2 rights. Musgrave was in. He'd gotten 2 lefts. He just got 2 rights. Just in front of them, Jeremy Mayfield came down pit road. No chassis adjustment. He got fuel and 2 left side tires. So basically, those 4 cars used 2 stops to get 4 fresh tires. Further down pit road, Jackaroo.
Well, Bill, the thing that happened on your end of pit road was not what happened with Jimmy Spencer. Spencer, if you recall, just before the drop of the yellow flag, was beating a couple of cars out off of a pit stop. The difference? They changed 4 tires. Spencer and company only changed 2. But I also want to update you on a conversation between Andy Graves during this caution and the leader, Terry Labonte. Now, Andy was trying to, like, chat up Terry a little bit. So he says, hey, you've been doing a great job. Silence. You know, especially you're doing a great job on pit road. Silence. He says, you know, I really think we can win this thing. Labonte goes, okay, let's check in with Jerry Punch.
Well, this caution flag, a huge break for Dale Jarrett. Remember, they had a problem, had to pit on lap 97 because they did not get the car completely full of fuel on their first pit stop when Dale left early before getting it full. He came in, topped the tank off at lap 108, so he is now back
on the cycle. Also pitting down toward turn one, the 43 car of John Andretti, right side tires, and Dick Trickle's car number 90, right side tires, and topping it off with fuel. Some cars getting advantage to take tires, but the big winner down here, Dale Jarrett, getting back on the rotation for fuel. Let's go back to Bill Weber.
Well, a problem for Ted Musgrave on the track. He's out of the car, a fire under the hood. James Lynch, a distributor caught fire. Do you know what happened?
We're really not sure what happened right now. Ted called back and said it quit running. Before we knew it, it was on fire, and he was having to bail out of it. So until we get it back here and look at it, we're not sure.
Okay, well, they just got a break with that caution to come in and get tires, but obviously good things turn bad quickly at Talladega.
Musgrave is okay. You saw him back in the cockpit riding along with the wrecker as his car is being taken back to the garage area. Back with more from Talladega in a moment. Flag racing here at Talladega in the Die Hard 500. We are under caution for the first time this afternoon. It came out when Billy Standridge cut a tire down the backstretch, scattered some debris, and then Ted Musgrave have a fire in his car. These overhead shots, courtesy of the Pennzoil copter cam flying around in the partly cloudy skies, and a perfect day for racing here at Talladega. Not too hot and just right.
And not wet.
Yes.
Like it was last year here at Talladega. Boy, what a break this caution flag was for so many teams. We had a four-car breakaway, and now we've got 28 cars nose to tail.
28 cars on the lead lap as the pace car brings the field off of corner number four. And we'll be getting the green flag here when the cars hit the line. Terry Labonte at the front of the field, followed by Jeff Gordon, Bobby Labonte, Kenny Wallace continuing that great run, and Bill Elliott running in fifth position. Chad Little is sixth, then Dale Earnhardt.
Green flag, green flag.
Ward Burton and Sterling Marlin complete the top 10.
Well, folks, remember how the race started? They ran side by side and finished on the rest. There's an opportunity right now to do the same thing. Now we see them three abreast off turn two already.
That's the only bad thing about having a caution in the middle of the race. You bunch up the field, and again, you increase the chances of something going wrong in this high-speed ballet.
Michael Walter down on the inside, diving down. He was running 13th on the restart, trying to use these slower cars to pass cars.
Caterpillar car, sponsored car there on the inside, driven by David Green. He is the first lap, first car off the lead lap in 29th position.
In the middle of another car, the Hopkins car that is a lap down. And already we're seeing about a 10-car breakaway.
Not only is Kenny Wallace doing a great job on the racetrack, but his pit crew doing a great job of getting him in and out of the pits that allows him to stay up there to battle with the front runners.
That's exactly. They made a pit stop on the green flag. He made a stop with the Labonte brothers, with Jeff Gordon, and guess what? He came out right behind them. So Newt Ward, all he fellas down in the squirty pits, take a bow.
This is his first restrictor plate race of 1988. Kenny Wallace was unable to qualify for the Daytona 500. Second pack, that's Sterling Marlin on the outside, Kyle Petty on the inside. Kyle a lap down. And again, these cars all bunched up now as they try to sort themselves out after the restart. But boy, you get awful close racing and you hold your breath for a while.
Yes, you do. Never see Michael Walker still on the bottom of the racetrack, still trying to use those slow cars to progress towards the front. Nothing happening up front. Terry Labonte still leads. Leading the second group.
And that second group is catching the tail end of the first group. That interval has been reduced by 1/10 of a second. From From 0.7 seconds down to 3, as that second group has gotten in line now, and as long as they stay nose to tail, they will be able to draft up to the lead group. But back here, they may not be able to do that because they're side by side.
Michael chose to go on the inside, and that lane so far is not working for him. Now we have almost 28 cars nose to tail. Here is Mark Martin's car as he follows Kenny Schrader.
He's in 14th position, running about 2 seconds behind Terry Labonte. Just ahead, Ken Schrader. Schrader in his 400th NASCAR Winston Cup start. The only driver in the top 10 in points coming into this race, not a member of a multi-car team.
Derek Cope drives down to the inside, tries to go by Dale Earnhardt. Meanwhile, they're side by side as Martin gets a great run on Schrader. Got to see Derek Cope.
Ooh.
Looks like Derek Cope might have made a slight error in judgment there, because he's lost one spot, about to lose two more spots.
The line just goes by, and nobody comes down to help him.
Jeremy Mayfield's climbed back one spot. The last time we saw points as of now, he was in fifth spot.
You are right. He is up in 27th position right now, and so that gains him a spot in the point standings. There is Schrader still running in the 10th position in the points.
Derek Cope was running what, fourth or fifth? Sixth, maybe. He's in jeopardy, falling all the way back to, this is the battle for 15th.
Yep.
He should be able to dive in between those two cars.
Ooh,
almost dived in the front of John Andretti. The car still continued to go by,
including Ernie Irvin. Riding along with the points leader, Rusty Wallace. He's in 16th. Rookie points battle still being led by Kenny Irwin. Kevin LePage and Jerry Nadeau are following, and Irwin is running the highest as of this moment among the rookies. We're riding along with Jerry
Nadeau.
He follows Kyle Petty through the corner.
Very early in the race, he was up front, but then had the bad pit stop, slid through the pits, and lost a lot of time on the racetrack. Terry Labonte is running the same car he won this race with last fall. It's performing flawlessly for him again.
And folks, believe it or not, we saw Derek Cope just a moment ago down on the inside trying to pass Earnhardt for, I guess, the sixth or seventh position. Derek Cope finally got back in line at 24th position.
Wow. And there is the line, as everybody is pretty much nose to tail all the way down the backstretch. From the Pennzoil copter cam, the field in front of the main grandstand here in the Trioval, the Pennzoil copter cam providing these overhead shots.
Speeds on these cars back up to 193 miles per hour. All these cars with four fresh tires probably will not see any of these cars break out of line for a few laps until these tires get a little bit of heat in them, and then the cars start slipping and sliding going across the racetrack. Then we'll start seeing some battles for position.
Joe Nemechek is the last car on the lead lap in 28th position, the winner of yesterday's Busch Series race here at Talladega. To find the fastest speed of time, we have to go all the way back to Ricky Rudd, who ran over 194 miles an hour. Make that Rusty Wallace at 194.4. Rudd came out third. John Andretti second fastest.
You see Rusty and Andretti. That's because there was some gap between the 88 car and those two, and they got a good run. And Rusty Wallace follows John Andretti. Dale Jarrett, Aaron Irvin back there.
Rusty finished 37th in this race last year and finished 10th in the fall race at Talladega. Here comes another at the line. We'll check the speed once again. Whoa, we go all the way down to Kenny Schrader.
And those three cars running together were the fastest cars. So you get a little bit of a gap between the car in front and your car. And Ward Burt trying to bring some cars by Chad Little. Sterling Marlin, Jimmy Spencer, he's got some help. Now Earnhardt moves over, tries to get some help from that draft of Ward Burton. He says, I want to go to the front too. Take me with you.
Dale Jarrett staying up high on the track. Maybe we'll come up there and help Chad Little.
Spencer has the 9 car, late speed, going to make it 3 deep, going into turn 1.
So that was single-file formation for a couple of laps, maybe even 3 or 4. Now has become 3 wide and 2. Look how close Rusty Wallace is drafting on Mark Martin. Oh, yeah. Man.
Yeah, he's close, all right.
Yes.
Very, very close.
Looking ahead from Rusty up to Mark Martin.
And Jimmy Spencer, we saw just a moment ago in the middle, is going backwards. Look at what a good run Rusty gets off the corner.
Mm-hmm. He has the best average finish this year of all the other drivers. That's one reason why he's in the lead in the point standings. A little bit of flat there on the right front of that car, Benny.
Right now, we've got some Fords running side by side. I tell you, they need to get back in line, or there's front packages going to drive away. We see Chad Little and Lake Speed. They'll get back in line a few laps, but it's going to be too late. Terry Labonte and Jeff Gordon are going to drive away from it. Now, they still continue to run side by side.
Right up on Mark Martin.
Looks like he might have a hood pin broken on the right side of the hood.
Yeah, it does. The Tabasco hot zone information. All of that close running and maybe even sometimes a bit of a bump from Rusty at 195 miles an hour. And a little touch of the brake there. Now he's side by side with John Andretti.
And Spencer's going to try to get on the bottom of the racetrack. Big Dick trickle up on the outside.
Look at this. Meanwhile, these guys have been battling among themselves. You can see about 7 cars still in line have pulled away a little bit. The 26 car, we understand, has dropped down to the 8th of the racetrack. They may have a caution, Johnny Benson. And the caution is out for the second time. There's fluid on the racetrack. And now look at the scramble in the backstretch.
Still racing back to the line, Jerry Punch.
A lot of crews are jumping for joy because they wanted a caution. They now are within their window. As the smoke comes out of the car number 28 of Kenny Irwin. But the crews down on pit road, Earnhardt's crew, the 18 crew, thinking now they can make their final pit stop and make it all the way on fuel. It may be close for a couple. We have just been told by the Goodrich crew of Dale Earnhardt that they can make it from here when they pit next time by.
We thought maybe the yellow car that you saw down there, Bobby Hamilton, was going to try to get his lap back. He did not. Bill Weber.
Well, the disappointment for Roush Racing this weekend continues for Johnny Benson. Motor got away. So it's a motor ailment for Johnny Benson. He's out along with Musgrave.
Caution flag comes out on the 130th lap here at Talladega Super Speedway as the 28 car of Kenny Irwin, the leader in the rookie battle this year, has taken his Haviland Ford behind the wall, as has Johnny Benson in the 26 car.
Yep. Kenny Irwin, we saw the smoke out of the back of the Texaco Haviland car as he went down the backstretch a moment ago.
Yeah, and it caused me great concern. I thought maybe he was putting down fluid that would result in cars behind him getting in trouble, or that he himself was in trouble.
There I see the group of cars. There we see the 28 car, and all of a sudden, out of the car starts coming smoke. Looks like an engine problem. Mm. And Sterling Marlin, Bobby Hamilton dove down to the inside. Still got Sterling. Hamilton drove down trying to get a lap back, did not make it.
So Kenny Irwin with a problem here behind the wall, as is Johnny Benson. Well, coming up next here on ABC Sports, Toyota presents the AMA Supercross Motorcycle Championship at Texas Stadium. The hottest Supercross riders tear up the track. Don't miss it. It's right after we conclude our coverage of the Diehard 500 here at Talladega on ABC Sports. Let's go down to Jackaroot as those on the lead lap come in.
Terry Labonte is glued to the marker in front of his pit. He will hit the marks, as does his teammate Jeff Gordon. Now the question mark for Labonte is whether he could go the rest of the way without another pit stop. A gas and go for Mark Barton, and he will make a gamble. Let's go to Jerry Punch as Jeff Gordon beats his teammate out.
Tires only for the 18 car, likewise for the 3 car. They should be able to make it all the way, providing they got them full of fuel. It is a mad scramble down pit road for what was probably the final pit stop of the day, unless we get another caution flag.
Boy, a busy, busy pit road and an even busier exit as everybody scrambles to get the best track position. And Kenny Wallace has a problem. Oh, no.
The right front tire does not have any lug nuts on it.
Oh.
He's trying his best to get back to his pit, and he's torn up the fender. We know how important aerodynamics can be, but we'll let tire stay up until he can get back to the pits. Stay on there. Just stay right there, tire. Maybe he can make it.
And it just rolled off, but he made it, or almost made it. Oh, a tough break for Kenny Wallace, because that car and the crew had performed so well here at Talladega today. So the second caution is out, and the restart should be coming up before too long. We'll be back after these messages and a word from our ABC stations. We are still under caution here at Talladega, our second caution of the afternoon. Let's go quickly to pit road and Jerry Punch.
Kenny Wallace is back on pit road. A moment ago, they had a problem in the pits. The right front tire changer, Jason Shapiro, got a lug nut stuck inside the gun and couldn't get but 2 lug nuts on. They were trying to hold Kenny Wallace up, and Kenny left, and that's why they lost the right front tire. They backed him up, came back in, put
the right side tire zone. He went back on the racetrack on the tail end of the lead lap. Still under caution. He just came back on the pit road, and they changed all four tires. So they are the last car on the lead lap. What a tough break for a crew that gets up at 5:30 in the morning during the week and goes to a local gym in Charlotte to try to get developed for these over-the-wall efforts.
Indeed. Well, you can keep up with what's going on in NASCAR by visiting their website, www.nascar.com. Also, their auxiliary site, NASCAR at 50, as you relive the last 50 years with NASCAR as it celebrates its 50th anniversary. ESPN will join in the celebration this coming Saturday night at 7 o'clock Eastern Time, NASCAR's night in Hollywood, a golden celebration. Several special guests scheduled to appear include Tim Allen, Jay Leno, Craig T. Nelson, Dwayne Eddy, Sister Sledge, and more. NASCAR's Night in Hollywood, Saturday night at 7 o'clock on ESPN. Well, pit stops have been completed here, and we're about ready to go back to green. There's the summary. Terry Labonte lost several positions. Jeff Gordon picked up one, and Kenny Wallace fell from 4th to 25th. Terry Labonte, we understand, came in a second time and topped off on fuel.
It'll be a smart move. Okay, it looks like it's going to boil down right now. 55 laps at the end of the race. And some cars, I'm afraid, cannot make it that far. Some of them can. Once again, looks like it could be a fuel mileage situation.
Jeff Gordon is leading for the first time today, and during the caution, Brent Bodine led one lap, the first laps that he has led in 1998. The last time he led was during the Pepsi 400 at Daytona last July.
Jeff Gordon's got a bunch of Fords in there. They're trying to go on the outside. There goes Elliott, Dale Jarrett, Mark Martin, and Michael Waltrip.
Petty comes down to help Jeff Gordon in that low line, but boy, they're being surpassed by those Fords and the Pontiac of Bobby Labonte, and the crowd is on its feet.
Yeah, I looked up and saw all those Fords behind them. Jeff Gordon said, that's not too good.
Look at Labonte, man, oh man.
Almost has some contact between Labonte and Michael Waltrip.
Michael Waltrip has never won a Winston Cup points-paying race. We got four Fords up front and then a Pontiac, and a Pontiac has never won a restrictor plate race in NASCAR Winston Cup competition. Here comes Bill Elliott off the banking as the leader.
Bobby Labonte dives down to the inside. He's going to try to do this on his own, as Dale Jarrett's going for the lead in turn one.
Jarrett drops to the inside of Bill Elliott, and now he will try to get the lead. He has led four laps previously here this afternoon and does it rather easily as he goes to the front. Bobby Labonte comes to second, and here comes Earnhardt to third.
Well, that was a perfect time for Bobby Labonte to make that move to the bottom, because Jarrett moved down there and gave him that draft that he so badly needed to get to the front.
Once again, the cars all bunched up, and you hold your breath for a while until they can get spread out just a little bit. We're on board with Michael Waltrip running in eighth position. Job. He's up here with the leaders at about sixth spot in the number nine Cartoon Network Ford.
He was the fastest Ford in qualifying. And Labonte goes by. Bobby takes the lead. Earnhardt is in second. Gordon now works his way back to third.
Jerry Punch has a report from pit road.
Checking on the fuel situation of the three cars down where I am. Dale Jarrett, Bobby Labonte, and Dale Earnhardt's crews, all three say they should be safe on fuel. They can make it the rest of the way. How about where you are, Jackaroot?
Jerry, that is not what my guys want to hear. Terry Labonte has four new tires. Jeff Gordon has two new tires. And guess what? The McDonald's car of Bill Elliott has no new tires, but all three say they don't think they have enough fuel to go the distance. They might have to do a quick gas and go before the end of this race, Bill Weber.
It has been a frustrating day for Roush Racing, but Mark Martin is certainly resurrecting their hopes of winning here. He is running well, back at the front, and has plenty of fuel to go the distance, according to crew chief Jimmy Fennig.
sounds like you're going to be right, Benny. If this thing goes green the rest of the way, it could come down to who has the best fuel mileage.
And look at Jerry Labonte. Started back in 23rd spot, already up to 11th. And following Martin, Michael Walsh, the 21 car. That's Labonte in the 5. Trying to get back to the front.
Information will show us that because he's running side by side, Mark Martin stuck there at 193 miles an hour, running side by side with Kyle Petty.
Yeah, we've seen that car run 195 all day long. Now it's 193. That's because the 44 car is beside of him. Jerry Nadeau, the 13 car, he is a lap down to 28th spot. Jared takes a look on the inside, trying to get by Jeff Gordon. Elliott says, I think I'll go with my Ford buddy.
Here's a First Plus Financial Field summary showing the point standings. As of now, Terry Labonte back to fifth position. Jeff Gordon moves up to second, just 71 behind Rusty. And Mayfield has moved back up to third. He came into this race in second spot. Look at Kyle Petty down to the inside of Bill Elliott.
That's because Elliott's running side by side with other cars, just slowing down. And now Terry Labonte is back by now. Getting back to the front.
Rusty Wallace way up high on the racetrack. Looks to the outside of Jerry Nadeau.
Man. Well, that's a situation you just hope that guy on the inside knows you're there. Now Labonte, he's in the middle trying to go, and he goes by Elliott in the middle.
Terry has really come up through the field from that pit stop, that second pit stop that he made to top off.
And Labonte is up to sixth spot from 25th.
Kyle Petty is not on the lead lap in that 44 car to the inside. He's in 27th position. Jackaroo?
Well, hey, guys, don't forget about that second stop. Think about the difference between two tires and four tires. Terry Labonte had a long stop, but he got four new Goodyears, and that's helped him in that run to the front.
Yes, indeed, it has. Now side by side, Lake Speed and Dale Earnhardt, and here comes Elliott inside.
Elliott's gotten a run again. Wardburg will give him a hand, and now Lake Speed gets caught in the middle of three abreast. Oh, Lake, there's somebody out there. Be careful.
It's Chad Little up there on the top of the racetrack. Now here comes Michael Waltrip in the 21 car.
And Kenny Wallace.
Despite the problem on pit road, that 81 car is still running well. He is.
Oh, and Earnhardt gets hurt. Elliott hard in the wall.
Major crash here on the front stretch. A car upside down. That's Bill Elliott. And Dale Earnhardt was on his side as he came down through the tri-oval. A major, major crash here at the tri-oval. Car still.
We see a wheel rolling across the racetrack. Knocked the wheel off somebody's car.
And that is exactly what we were talking about. When the cars get bunched up,
and there is. Oh, man, what great news that is. That's Bill Elliott taking his visor up. He's taking his gloves off like he's in the garage. There comes John Andretti. And look at this car.
Oh, my gosh. And a fire burning there in the engine compartment. But we saw from the in-car camera that Bill Elliott was moving around inside. And, man, that is great, great news. The 9 car of Lake Speed has been severely damaged on the right front. Let's take a look at the replay of what happened when the cars were here right before they crossed the starting line.
There's Elliott. Ward Burton gets in the side of Earnhardt. Just touches him. Elliott in there on the roof, sliding across. We see Chad Little going down, hit Michael Waltrip. The 3 car gets banged from Jerry Nadeau, I think. Elliott's car now back on its wheels. We see Schrader down on the inside. Bobby Hamilton, heavy damage to Schrader's car.
Chad Little involved. Wow. A scary moment here at Talladega. Again, we take a look at Ward Burton making slight contact with Dale.
Oh, and Bill hit that wall so hard.
Bill getting out of the car, Jerry.
Well, the best news a crew could have is when a driver can actually talk to him, and they did. We're able to communicate with Bill Elliott. They have also talked, I'm told, down here with Dale Earnhardt, able to talk after the cars have come to a rest. And what a whale of a lick. Elliott, a little bit groggy. The safety crews are on the scene. They will have him out on a stretcher, taking to the Hardwick Caraway Medical Center infield care center to take a look at Bill Elliott. But thankfully, awake and alert, a little bit groggy, but getting out of the race car, and the red flag will come out because there is debris all over this racetrack.
Well, we thought we were going to make it without one of these harrowing accidents. There is Dale Earnhardt, and that is also good news. And Bill is walking around. Boy, he's pretty groggy, but it looks like he's okay.
He refused the stretcher, and Earnhardt's checking on him, and oh, man.
This is the ride that Bill Elliott took from his in-car camera. Let's ride with him. Camera worked all the way through. Here's the other angle of it. Up hard into that wall.
Hard in that wall. Unbelievable contact in that wall.
Fortunately, the car did not get up into the catch fencing as Bobby Allison's did several years ago. But boy, there is a lot of damaged race cars. But apparently, no driver injuries from this major accident that's brought out the red flag in the Die Hard 500 at Talladega. Kyle.
He was in the wreck too.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now these guys got to build another car for Daytona.
Yep.
They just built this one for here.
Mm.
Yeah. Yes, Neil.
Yep. Okay. Yeah. Sure.
Yeah.
Yes. What? Oh, okay. The FedEx Championship Series. We never have mentioned that.
Okay.
That. Yep.
Yeah. Anybody got any idea how many cars were involved? 15 of them. Okay.
Okay.
Oh, man.
Boy, Schrader got hit real hard, didn't he?
Yeah.
By Hamilton.
Hmm. Now.
You mean Michael Walter? Oh, not Mike Walter. Okay, good. Schrader, who took a real hard shot from Bobby Hamilton in the melee.
Well, Bobby, take a look at some of the debris that they've started to rip off of Kenny Schrader's car, but under red flag conditions, they can't work anymore. Kenny, first of all, you took one whale of a wallop out there.
No, it wasn't too bad. We just bent all the light stuff, so little car didn't hit too hard, but it's going to be a long time to fix it.
You know, we talked about at the open of the show that a momentary bobble for some is an opportunity, for others is a catastrophe, and that you guys have to operate on instinct. You don't have a margin for error anymore.
No. You know, first off, all the smoke goes up, and you either make it through or you don't. And we basically cleared everything that was in the smoke, but we had to cut left, and someone got us in the left rear, and then we spun around and hit someone. But, hey, you're just long for the ride on those things. That once the initial contact starts, it don't make much difference.
Now, believe it or not, guys, they can't even decide whether they can get this car back into action or not until the racetrack goes back to caution. Bill Weber, right now, they're all just standing around, like waiting for it to go back to yellow.
And it's good to see Morgan Shepherd standing around. I know you'd rather be out on the track in the car, but you're all right.
Yeah, I'm fine. Got banged around a little bit. The Lowe's Chevrolet was running good. You know, we was just sitting there riding, and next thing I know, all I could see was smoke. A couple of cars got together, I reckon, right in front of us, and there it went. You know, I really expected this to happen earlier in the race when cars was all over the place. I reckon that's when it happens, though, when you're kind of off guard.
Okay, that's Morgan Shepherd. Jerry Punch is with Michael Waltrip.
Well, the damage may look severe to the 21 car, the Citgo Ford, but actually it's probably minimal compared to some of the other cars that have been carried by us on pit road. Michael's still sitting in his car. Mike, I got to ask you, what from your vantage point could you see out there?
I just saw the three get turned sideways, and it happened right in front of me, so I turned to the left to try to squirt by, and somebody came out of that mess and hit the Citgo Taurus in the door, which almost spun it, but I corrected it and drove back here. I mainly just have no chassis damage, mainly cosmetic damage. And that's what we're gonna work on as soon as we get ready to go here. As Kenny Wallace said in Texas, it's mainly superficial or superstition. Now, wait a minute, there's one of them works.
All right, and folks, he didn't even hit his head in that accident. He's fine. That's just Michael Waltrip. But take a look at his race car. There's some pretty significant superstition, as he called it, some superficial damage. The left front fender is gone. The right front fender has been sheared away. They're going to do some work on this car, but right now under the red flag, no one can work on the race cars while they have the red flag waved to the field.
19 cars were involved in one way or another in this crash. Take a look at the list of drivers who suffered some kind of damage in the accident. But Bill Elliott and Dale Earnhardt took the wildest rides, and they got out of their cars and walked to the ambulance. We have many, many replays of this crash. We'll take a look at them when we come back.
Right in the middle of the screen, he gets tagged by the 22. He goes down and just hits the 94 in the right rear and turns Bill head on in the wall. Now, the other cars behind, they have nowhere to go. We see Derek Cope spinning down through there. All in all, 19 cars involved. I mean, if you were behind, folks, where would you go? Another angle.
Elliott's car gets over on its side. It does not turn over completely because now it's going to turn back onto its wheels. But those cars that you see backwards and sideways, you would have seen airborne and maybe turning over were it not for the roof flaps that were developed a few years ago by NASCAR.
And watch. Now you're back in Bobby Hamilton in the four car. Where would you go? There's no place to go. You just ride it into smoke.
Visibility is zero with all the smoke that arises from the cars. Now with Mark Martin.
Just listen. And his windshield looks just like our camera lens there.
Yep.
Now watch. Let's see the 22 car. I thought maybe the left front touched the apron and put him up into Earnhardt, but I don't know if that's the case or not. He goes up, just touches Earnhardt, and he gets in the 94 car. And Sterling Marlin says, thank God I got through that.
Michael Waltrip says he has cosmetic damage. Let's see how it occurred.
Yeah.
He's going to need a lot of lipstick and rouge to fix the damage that was caused by Chad Little when he was slid into. So we do have a red flag here as the debris is being cleaned up past the starting line for turn one. More after these messages and a word from our ABC station.
Well, Dale, how are you?
Hot.
Other than that, and that's about all he... We're gonna move in here just a little bit. Okay. You all right?
Yeah. Okay. Good shape.
What just happened, Dale?
I don't know. Somebody turned me from behind and turned Elliot. Just about the same thing happened to me, that happened to me in 96 here. So it was just a big wreck. The fire came off Elliot's car and singed my hair and burnt my mustache up a little bit. I had to grow some new ones.
Okay. Obviously, a lot of close racing. Talladega. What was the day like up to that point?
Good. It's not good racing, though. Y'all can talk about all you want. It ain't good racing.
Okay, he's going to try and get through. And Bill Elliott, we're told, will be leaving the track via ambulance, being taken next door. There's an airport that is adjoining to this facility. Bill has his plane there. He's going to get in his plane and fly home and see his doctor there. We're told his only injury, which is minor, he just had his breath knocked out of him. So Bill Elliott is okay, and we've heard from Dale Earnhardt. Let's go to Jack Arute.
Well, a man that had a great run going in the John Deere car, Chad Little, it just isn't going to work your way today. I mean, the car is tore up. Tell us what happened.
Well, I'll be honest with you. It happened about four cars in front of me, and all I saw is the 22 car and the 3 car come streaking right in front of us, and I turned to the left, and they said on reviewing it that we just barely got involved, but the second hit is what got me. First one wasn't so bad, but I'm fine. Say hi to Mom and Dad, and we'll just, you know, it's a shame, but that's part of the dangers of restrictor plate racing. We just almost expect one of these each time we race, right? Either Daytona or Talladega. We didn't have one in Daytona, so you knew we were going to have one here. And it's unfortunate. I like restrictor plate racing. I don't mind it a bit, but this is the unfortunate part about it, is when you got 20 cars so tightly packed together, somebody makes a mistake, somebody gets turned, it's going to be a big pileup.
Is part of the situation with restrictor plate racing the fact that if somebody does get crossed up, you can't give them a break because you don't have time to give them a break?
Maybe not. You know, it is for the guys that are third and fourth back from the accident where it started, but you know, usually it takes two cars to be in a wreck, generally. Or even, let's say, somebody loses it by themselves. There's so many cars that are so close together, it's going to take them all out if the track gets it all blocked. You can't avoid it. And that's really what the deal is. It's not that the horsepower, it's not the restrictor plate. That's just the running so close together is a product of that, and that's what causes the wrecks.
And that's Talladega. Bob?
Yes, indeed. It's something that you hate to see, but it is inevitable. We will be going back to Green Flag Racing here before too long. Next on ABC Sports, after our coverage of this race, Hollis's perspective. Almost involved with Michael Waltrip, but it looked like Rusty made it through unscathed.
I don't think he got a scratch.
Now the cars have started rolling again. We are under a yellow flag condition, and now the crews can work on their cars. Here comes Bobby Hamilton down pit row. The red flag lasted 27 minutes, and as you can see, they indeed have gone to work on their cars. Ricky Rudd's Tide crew busy at work. So the cars now roll once again, and we will have the restart in just a few moments. There are 46 laps to go in the Die Hard 500 at Talladega Super Speedway.
Concerned about fuel consumption. Well, here's what Andy Graves did. They took the empty fuel cans and they weigh them on this pad right here, and that they then can determine, because it's 7 pounds per gallon for fuel, exactly how much fuel went into the car. Seeing how they've already had a couple of stops, they can calculate what their fuel mileage is. Well, here's the good news. Andy Graves says that extra stop when they took the extra fuel has given them enough to go the distance. Now, here's the bad news. His teammate behind me, now Ray Evernham and Jeff Gordon, all they did during the red flag was discuss fuel conservation measures. They also, on top of everything else, have got an intermittent radio problem. Guys?
Well, the green flag is going to be coming out in one more slow lap, so we'll sneak in another quick break and be back for Green Flag Racing at Talladega.
yellow, we were drinking them. The car don't seem too bad, but we were drinking them after the yellow.
Green, 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 green.
Just as you rejoin us, the green flag comes back out after a long red flag. Bobby Labonte at the front of the field. There are 15 cars on the lead lap.
But a couple of those are damaged as we see Bobby Labonte, the 18, the pole setter. Lead as he come off the second corner. There we see the 24 car and 81, Kenny Wallace.
The running order in the upper left of your screen. It's an amazing comeback for Kenny Wallace, who, remember, had that problem on pit road. Went off without the lug nuts tightened. He is back up in contention for the win. But right now, it is Bobby Labonte, Dale Jarrett, Jeff Gordon, and Kenny Wallace running one through four. Back in fifth is Jimmy Spencer, Terry Labonte sixth, and Sterling Marlin seventh.
Our points leader, Rusty Wallace, Jeremy Mayfield. Right now, Jeremy Mayfield is running in 10th spot, and Rusty is running in 12th. Both those cars able to dodge the big crash.
39 laps to go. When we show you the remainder of how the field is running, now we're going to show you a first plus financial field summary, and we'll show you how their position on the racetrack now affects the point standings. And Jeremy Mayfield is back up into second. He was as low as fifth in the point standings at one time during this race. Jeff Gordon fourth, and Terry Labonte fifth. Jeff Gordon was second in the point standings at one time during the race.
There's a lot of, as always, in NASCAR Winston Cup racing, when the car is involved in the crash, they try to fix it, get it back on the racetrack. NASCAR has told the team that they must maintain a 56-second lap to be able to stay on the track.
You can see some damage there in the front, in the left front of Rusty Wallace's car, affecting the car aerodynamically, but really he got through that crash with relatively little damage.
Back to the lead, Labonte, Jarrett. Laps to go. 37 now. 37 laps to go.
The 22 car is Ward Burton, and he is the one that made initial contact with Dale Earnhardt to begin that series of crashes that we had and cars turning up on their side. There he is. He's running in ninth position, so he got through okay.
MBNA Pontiac following the Skittles Pontiac of Ernie Irvin. This is right along with Ernie Irvin, or A1 Steak Sauce onboard camera, as he tries his best to close up on Sterling Marlin. That's Sterling right in front of him.
Ernie has not led today, but he had led at least one lap in the last 10 races here. Lake Speed is the red car that you see running there to your left on the inside of the racetrack. One of those cars that was involved in the big crash but has gotten back out there. Ernie Irvin was also the pole sitter for the race here last October. Currently running eighth. Here's the shot from the Pennzoil copter cam, the first four. We got a Pontiac, a Ford, a Chevy. Running first, second, and third. There they're passing by Derek Cope. Now we're down to track level. This is the bumper cam of Bobby Labonte. Looking back on second place, Dale Jarrett. Well, if a Pontiac wins today, it's going to break a couple of records. First of all, it's going to be the first Pontiac win since Richard Petty won it here in 1983, and it will be the very first race that Pontiac has ever won with a restrictor plate.
At Daytona or Talladega.
Right. speed is back up to well over 190 miles an hour after that red flag. Here comes Bobby Labonte across the stripe to complete lap number 154. We have had 9 different leaders here this afternoon. From Terry Labonte, who has led 67 laps, to Brett Bodine, who has led 1.
Now we see Ernie Irvin, and you can see how the vibration, there's not a lot of vibration as he just relaxes down straight away, puts his arm up on the windowsill like he's going down the store after a loaf of bread, talking to the crew, checking the mirror, turns in the corner. Much vibration. I'm not seeing as much as I expected to see with this shot.
Jack Arut has more on Ernie Irvin.
Well, Benny, before that red flag situation, Ernie Irvin was conversing with his crew, and they were mired back there in about 16th or 17th spot. And the crew radioed to him and said, "Hey, when are you going to decide to get serious about this?" And he says, "Oh, in a little while." Radioed into him now and says, "How do you like me now?"
Along in 8th position. Ward Burton right behind him and Sterling Marlin in front of him.
Never see the 2 Pontiacs of Irvin and Burton.
Up front, meanwhile, it's still Bobby Labonte, Dale Jarrett, Jeff Gordon, Kenny Wallace, Jimmy Spencer, and the second pack is catching that lead pack. Jeremy Mayfield, Rusty Wallace, and Randy LaJoy, who's having another good race here today. And if they stay in line, they'll be able to draft right up there and be among the top 9. 156 laps completed out of 188 of the Die Hard 500. Kenny Wallace wins this race, it'll be really unbelievable. Yeah. Yeah.
They lost 4/10 that time.
To go, 30 laps to go. Now we're going to be okay.
Yeah.
Sports here at Talladega this afternoon for the Die Hard 500. Get up to speed with trackside stories. You can download videos, interviews, news, and results. First at the finish line on ABC Sports Online at AOL, keyword ABC Sports.
By the way, some of the cars involved in the crash back on the racetrack, Bobby Hamilton, Joe Nemechek, John Andretti, and Mark Martin, have been black flagged for too slow.
Still about nine cars, actually six running right together and then a little bit back to the next three. Jeff Gordon decides it's time to make a move here, but is anybody going to go with him? He could go from third to who knows where.
The 18 moved over to try to help Gordon, try to give him some draft. But meanwhile, on the outside, we've got three Fords, Jarrett, Wallace, and Jimmy Stretcher teamed up.
And Jeff is going to go back to sixth spot, it looks like.
But he's got a teammate, Terry Labonte, back there, who has a very fast car. And right now, Jarrett and Kenny Wallace trying to get by Bobby Labonte. That last time through the trial, we almost had a duplication of that last crash. Gordon and Jarrett almost made contact.
Jimmy Spencer running there in fourth position is a former winner here at Talladega. He won the fall race in 1994. Earlier, we saw the second pack closing in on the first pack. Not so anymore.
No, we see the ninth place car, Ward Burton. Look, he ran 49.5 with his fast lap. And Mayfield, the best lap he could run was 49.9, but won 50.4, lost almost 1 second that one lap.
And almost 2 seconds from 155 to 159. Now to Jerry Punch.
NASCAR has black flagged some of the cars that were damaged in that incident, saying they have to run a minimum of 56 seconds a lap to keep up. That's about 6.5, 7 seconds behind where the leaders are running. Otherwise, they become a hazard on the racetrack. That's why Bobby Hamilton has been brought in behind the wall. They are trying to attach a new carbon fiber Chevy Monte Carlo nose to his machine so he can get back up to speed.
Wow, that was so close, Benny. I think there was contact between Kenny Wallace and Terry Labonte, and I thought we were going to have another one.
I did too. As we see, Dale Jarrett has taken the lead. Here comes Spencer. No place, nobody to dance with on the outside.
But position certainly being shuffled. They're three wide through the 33 degrees of banking in turn two. Wallace in the middle, and now Ward Burton makes it a two abreast formation. But the positions have certainly been scrambled here in the last couple of laps.
And Terry Labonte, we saw him make that pit stop, go back to 25th, is now back up to second place. There's our pole sitter, Labonte on the outside, hung out to dry.
Dale Jarrett leads now with Terry Labonte running in second position. And a lap ago, as they came off of corner number four, we almost had another one.
The five car and Kenny Wallace. Labonte is going to try to turn under Kenny Wallace, and right there, if Kenny Wallace had turned down the hill one more foot, we would have had a duplicate of the crash we had a moment ago. Although, fortunately, not as many cars would have been involved.
And it would have probably wiped out about five or six, though, and that's bad enough. So now we'll see if all that jostling and running side by side slowed down this first pack and has allowed the second group of cars to close in.
No, they see they're running side by side.
Yep.
If they get in line, they might help. But right now, they're 7 seconds behind the leader. And just five laps ago, they were just 2.5 seconds behind.
Brett Bodine having a good run. He's on the lead lap, battling alongside Rusty Wallace for the 11th position. The paychecks floor looking good here today.
Yes, he is. That's Jeremy Mayfield, by the way. They are hard to tell apart.
Is pulling away from a 2.2 second interval on lap 158 to a 5.5 second interval on lap 162. More close racing back there in the backstretch.
Spencer pushing Labonte by Sterling Marlin.
And Dale Earnhardt is returning to the racetrack. His car is returning to the racetrack. Who is it, Jerry?
Well, Dale Earnhardt is left in the racetrack, but the crew wanted to try to be able to get the car back out, so they got the car repaired to make a lap or two, and that is Kyle Petty in the car number three. Kyle agreed to get in the car, take it back out for some laps to try to pick up some positions for Earnhardt and the Goodrich team. Kyle Petty in the three car.
Well, if he can complete a couple of laps, he will perhaps move up in the standings. Meanwhile, look at this battle for the lead as Labonte is challenging Jarrett again. And now the Pontiacs and the Chevys are ganging up on Jarrett's four, but he gets back into second. But here comes Gordon, and he's got Bobby Labonte with him.
And Jarrett was leading the race. He's going back to fourth place. And Spencer, if he can't get in, might put it back to fifth spot.
Indeed. Jarrett. Jimmy Spencer will come to fourth, and Jarrett falls from first to fifth, but he does get it ahead of Sterling Marlin.
They're in trouble now. They got Team Hendrick running 1-2.
It's going to be tough for anybody to challenge the Hendrick boys, but we've got still a lot, 23 laps to go in this one, so a lot of racing yet to come. The Diehard 500 continues from Talladega Super Speedway. We'll be right back.
Guys, listen to this. Now they're trying to find another driver to get in a three car, but they just called Kyle and said, hey, your car is about ready. You got to bring that one in and get in ours.
Gee,
they're hunting for somebody to get in a three. Any of you available?
I know.
God. Less than 20 laps to go at Talladega. The Pennzoil copter cam circling overhead and showing you the lead group of cars. Now five in the lead draft with Sterling Marlin, a close sixth position. Don't forget, coming up next here on ABC Sports, the AMA Supercross Motorcycle Championship from Texas Stadium right after our coverage of the Diehard 500. By the way, the FedEx Championship Series IndyCar race, the Bosch Spark Plug Grand Prix presented by Toyota at Nazareth, was rained out today. You can see that tomorrow at 1 o'clock Eastern on ESPN.
It looks like Sterling Marlin is in jeopardy of being left. We have five car breakaway right now, and Sterling Marlin is about a second behind, and he's got no one behind to push him. So
Ernie Irvin and Kenny Wallace have also lost draft. And Ward Burton. Here's a Napa field summary with the point positions as of now. Team cars back up front. Jeff Gordon picking up a spot and losing his spot in the top five. And the sixth, Bobby Labonte up three, Earnhardt down one, and Spencer up four to 10th position in points right now.
Chad Lilly gone back on the racetrack in the John Deere car. Black flagged him a moment ago for running too slow.
There are 13 cars. is currently on the lead lap. Rusty Wallace, the last car on the lead lap. His teammate Jeremy Mayfield is 12th. Brett Bodine, 11th. As the laps are winding down here at Talladega, Team Hendrick, two of the three cars, are first and second.
Now Sterling Marlin has gone 2 seconds behind the leader, so he has lost the lead draft.
As things wind down, we're going to take another break so that we can be here for the conclusion of this race. Who will be among these top five?
Car. You know, he's 14th, first car a lap down.
Kevin LePage.
I think he'll take 3 points away. Point for each driver. Nothing has changed. The group remains in the same order. We are here now until the checkered flag drops, and that will be in 12 more laps. It's still Terry Labonte, Jeff Gordon, Bobby Labonte, Jimmy Spencer, and Michael Waltrip is shredding a tire down the backstretch. But he has done an apron of the racetrack. Should not be any problem for these cars that are up to speed.
They come down the backstretch in excess of 192 miles an hour.
See Kenny Schrader back out there with a new front end on his car.
By the way, Joe Nemechek is now driving the three car, and Kyle Petty has gone over into his own car to finish as many laps as possible. Kyle just got the black flag, so his run didn't last very long.
So the three cars playing musical drivers.
Yes, it has. Dale Earnhardt left the racetrack after being involved in the crash. Kyle took a couple of laps, and Joe Nemechek drives the car now. They come out of two and down the backstretch, and when they cross the line next time, there'll be just 10 more laps to go.
Back and forth and fifth, we've got a couple of Fords, Jimmy Spencer and Dale Jarrett. but I'm not sure that they can team up and do anything with Team Hendrick. The car's running 1-2. I'm sorry, Bob. We talk about tires blowing apart and damaging the fender. Look, when that tire comes apart, the damage it does, it's almost trying to tear the hood off the car.
Yep. And that's what happened to Michael Waltrip just a few moments ago. But we have no caution on the racetrack, and Michael has made it to his pit. All right, back to the racetrack now with 9.5 laps to go. Terry Labonte did not have a good outing last week at Martinsville. He finished in 26th position, but his most recent win in NASCAR Winston Cup competition was here last October. And he is in front at the moment with Jeff Gordon right behind him. We're riding with Terry's brother, Bobby, who is the pole sitter. Now, the 76 Racing Challenge money was won last weekend by Bobby Hamilton after starting from the pole, won the race. So it's back to $7,600, and Bobby Labonte will win it if he can come out on top.
Terry Labonte, last October, I think this is the same car he won with. It was very, very fast then, and it seems to be the same again this spring.
Here's the record that Terry has established at this track. 38 starts, 2 wins, 10 top fives, and 18 top tens.
Jeff Gordon wants by his teammate. Look, he's pulling over. He's saying to Bobby Labonte, let's go. Come on, hook up with me. Let's go. Now let's go to the outside. Come on, Bobby. Come on, Bobby. And Gordon's going to try to go. Who's Bobby?
He is going by himself, Benny.
But will those brothers help each other, or will they help Jeff Gordon? Now, David Garrett's going to come on the outside. He'll help Jeff Gordon.
Wow, so positions are being shuffled here now. Jarrett joins the bottom line and leaves Gordon hung out. And look how close Jimmy Spencer is drafting on Bobby Labonte.
Jeff wanted to go, but he couldn't get anybody to go with him. He goes from second back to fifth. Now here goes Jarrett trying to get on the inside of Spencer.
And will Gordon help him? Almost touched in the backstretch. And now we may see these three cars lose the draft here as the Labonte guys, brothers, pull away.
Very close between Jarrett and Gordon.
Very.
And Gordon backs up, gets behind Jarrett. 6.5 laps.
Terry and Bobby, first and second. The best finish Terry has had this year. He's finished sixth on two different occasions, most recently at Texas. Bobby Labonte, of course, won at Atlanta.
Seem to catch up. Is he in danger of losing the draft? Gordon is dropping back.
It seems like he might.
He's a half second behind the leaders. And those four are pretty close together. Gordon may lose the draft.
By the way, the number three car has been black flagged and is out of the race, ending a 53 race streak in which it was running at the conclusion of the race. And Jeff, it looks like Benny is losing the draft.
Well, he's about the same as he was. If he can just get these guys in front to race a little bit, he can catch up. As long as they stay in line, he might be in trouble.
Jack Arute has more from the pit area.
Benny, that's actually the exact discussion that he and Ray Evernham are having right now. Where Ray heard on the radio from Jeff, hey, I've lost the draft. Ray went back and said, look, they'll start dicing it up soon. Just be patient.
He's 1 second back now. He's losing about 2/10 of a second per lap.
Terry Labonte's best finish this year was second at Bristol, not at Texas. He was second at Bristol. Can he hold on and record his first win of 1998? And the crew members watch these last few laps.
All these pit crews have satellite dishes on their toolbox. They all watch the race along with us.
This will complete lap number 184. There are four more laps to go.
Jeff Gordon is now a little over a second and a quarter back. Once again, about 0.2 seconds per lap.
Last fall, Terry Labonte won this race. Bobby finished second. That's exactly the way they're running now as we get down to it. But two Fords are right behind them. Will they be teaming up before the checkered flag? Jimmy Spencer's best finish so far this year has been at Rockingham. He was fourth, so he has his best run of the year going. There's a second group of cars that we've been keeping our eye on. Ernie Irvin, Kenny Wallace, Ward Burton, and Sterling Marlin.
These guys are running 6th, 7th, 8th, and 9th. They are about 7 seconds behind the lead pack, those four cars there.
They pass by Mark Martin, who is now 8 laps down in 23rd position. Joe Gibbs, the coach, looks on. His driver is running second.
Here comes Labonte crossing the line, completing another lap. Two more to go. And Jeff Gordon is now almost 3 seconds behind. As a matter of fact, he might be in jeopardy of that second pack catching him.
Now maybe the time has come to move. Bobby Labonte goes high, coming off turn two. Down the backstretch, Jimmy Spencer moves up behind him. They're gonna shuffle Terry back, it looks.
Here comes Jarrett. Got two fours together, the Chevrolet goes back to fourth. Oh, Bobby could be in trouble now. One lap to go, a little over one lap to go, and he's got two fours behind him.
Here comes the white flag. One more lap to go. It's Bobby Labonte, Jimmy Spencer, Dale Jarrett, and Terry Labonte as they hit for the banking in turns one and two for the final time today. Now we'll watch the Fords. Will they team up? Pontiac has never won a NASCAR Winston Cup restrictor plate race. Now Jimmy Spencer begins to look to the inside of Bobby Labonte as they travel down the backstretch. But he makes no move.
He tried to make a move. He's got the accelerator pedal on the floor. He's just not able to get the momentum the way he needs to. Here he goes diving down to the inside. Jared goes with no hit right now.
Bobby blocks the way to the inside. Now Spencer looks high. He looks low once again. Gets down to the apron of the racetrack. Here comes Bobby Labonte. Spencer tries desperately, but he can't do it. And Bobby Labonte has won the diehard 500.
And Jeff Gordon will run fifth spot. Here, teammates battle for the lead, and Rusty Wallace in front of Jeremy.
And Rusty is going to beat Jeremy to the line. And the 91 of Kevin LePage was in that battle. Oh, no, he wasn't. He was a lap down in 14th position.
And Darrell Walker missed the wreck. He said he knew he was going to be in the wreck. He missed the wreck and finished 15th today.
Kenny Wallace finished in 7th position. So the race has been run, and Bobby Labonte is the winner. Robin Roberts, we're going to throw it back to you in the wide world of sports studio in New York. We'll be back here for the winner interview.
Another exciting yet difficult Talladega race. First of all, gone, Slop.
Be ready in 10 minutes. Just wait on us. What's your hurry? You got 3 hours. Oh, you got 2 hours. Bobby Labonte is in victory lane here at Talladega Super Speedway, having won the Diehard 500.
Well, Bobby Labonte, the first restrictor plate victory for Pontiac, will have your name next to it. And you're celebrating. You are excited about this one, aren't you?
And I won over a mile and a half racetrack. Man, I've been, I feel like I've been restricted. So I tell you what, this Interstate Pontiac was awesome all week long. And it just performed flawlessly, and I got to thank Interstate Batteries, Pontiac, Goodyear Tires. Heck, we got so many Coca-Cola, South Thrust Bank, got Centos Champion, Ditch Witch, Husqvarna. I mean, you know, it's just been a great day. And Jimmy Makar and all them guys, they just put together a great race car and just got lucky. And anytime you can finish a restrictor plate race, you got to feel lucky no matter where you finish.
Hey, let's go back to when Jeff Gordon was signaling to you when you guys were running behind your brother, and all of a sudden he's saying, come on with me, come on with me, and you didn't go. Did you know something about this race car?
Well, I knew it was pretty good when we were out front, and I knew that Jimmy Spencer was going to help us. So, you know, whenever we got hooked up together earlier last year, or this year at Daytona, it was fast, and this time here we got together, and he was going to hang with me. So I owe him a big steak next Saturday night at Fontana, so I'm going to cook that for him. But it was just a deal where, you know, I knew I needed to be second when the last lap came down or last time to make a move.
Well, that's it from our McDonald's interview from Victory Lane. So let's check in with Jerry Punch and Mr. Excitement.
Indeed, he was Mr. Excitement, Jimmy Spencer, from 22nd to 2nd. And, Jimmy, let's talk about the last three laps. First of all, you helped Bobby Labonte make the pass for the lead.
We knew that the Team Winston car wasn't good enough to win this race on its own. There's no question. And you need to make a friend, you know. And I made a friend, Bobby Labonte, Daytona for the 500 and helped him get second. And I got second today with him, with all his help, you know. And I really appreciate that. I sort of knew there was going to be no teammates at the end of that race. I mean, I know Gordon and Labonte are teammates, stuff like that, but the Team Winston, no bull car. We're out there by ourselves, and we made a deal with Bobby, and it worked out for us.
Last lap, Jimmy, you made a high move, a low move. Looked like you might have a shot going into three. Did you think you had any shot at getting Bobby Labonte?
Maybe if his carburetor broke or something. you never know, though, Jerry. I mean, I was going to give it everything I had, and you know what I mean? Dale made a run at him there, and he blocked it to the top of the racetrack going into the third turn, and then I shot back to the bottom. And without having a really good run with a guy right on pushing you, it's pretty tough. And I congratulate Bobby Labonte and Joe Gibbs. say hi to my son and daughter at the house and my mom's home and my mother-in-law. I never get to say that much on TV, so I appreciate that, and I want to thank the Lord for a safe race.
Indeed we do. Jimmy Spencer finishes second. Dale Jarrett finished third. He's standing by with Bill Weber.
And it's a coke and a smile for Dale Jarrett. You dodged some harrowing moments out there, and I came home with a good finish.
Yeah, we sure did. And we want to congratulate Bobby Labonte and Jimmy Makar. They had a great day, a great race car. And just thank the Lord that the other guys are okay. You know, we all sit there and wonder when it's going to happen, and I was fortunate enough to be in front of it, but I'm just glad the guys are okay. That's the main thing, is we come out of here and everybody's in one piece, so to speak, and we can go on to the next race and get by here.
Tell me about your day.
It was exciting. I made a wrong move on the very start of the race and worked myself towards the back and then had to get back towards the front. But my car was awful good. I got a little bit tight there at the end. And you know, maybe I shouldn't have gone to the front, but I felt like I needed to do that and give it a try. But knowing they were going to come back by me, I was hoping I might get in about third, but it's fifth the best I could do. So, but good day for us. We picked up points on all the guys that are in front of us there, and that's what we were here for.
Okay, so a good finish for Dale Jarrett. He comes home with another critical top five. Bob, let's take a look at the results.
And the yellow arrows indicate the drivers who led a lap. Terry Labonte with the double yellow arrows indicates that he led the most laps. 13 cars were on the lead lap at the finish, and Darrell Waltrip pulled out a 15th place finish.
Take a look at 16 through 30. Steve Grissom, a good run for him. Michael Waltrip led a lap in the big crash, finished back in 21st. Kenny Schrader, and they would see all those cars, most of those cars involved in the crash, except Jeff Burton.
And what's happened in the point standings? Well, everybody in the top five stayed the same. The big change was in 6th through 10th. Bobby Labonte gained 4 positions, Elliott and Earnhardt down 1, and Spencer gained 4 up into the top 10. NASCAR Winston Cup Racing next weekend. NASCAR Bud Pole qualifying from Fontana, California on the Deuce at 5:30 Friday. Saturday, a Winston West race at 3 o'clock, and then happy hour at 11 o'clock Eastern time. On Sunday, RPM Today at 2:30, NASCAR Today at 3 o'clock, and the California 500 presented by NAPA. Live coverage at 3:30 Eastern time on ESPN next Sunday afternoon. So an exciting race here at Talladega. Big crash, but everybody is okay, and Bobby Labonte walks away as the winner. Thanks to Jack Arute, Jerry Punch, Bill Weber, and Benny Parsons. Now to our Wide World of Sports studio in New York. Here is Robin Roberts.
We may not find him again with this thing. I want to go to the other.